Welcome to the house with the mouse. It is Wayne Radio TV on the stream for you and me. Today we're playing AI Dungeon 2 multiplayer. A fan favorite and a house favorite. We love it. Thank you, Hulk Hogan's Pasta Mania.
My name is based on a real restaurant Hogan had during his run in WCW.
Oh, I'm well aware of Hulk Hogan's Pasta Mania. Subscribe to me, please. Radio TV bought by Disney confirmed. What gave you that idea? Oh, House with the Mouse or whatever the fuck I said?
Three.
No, that's not what I mean. Ryan Curtis, thank you so much. Yo, welcome, Dragon TV. Thanks for tuning in. What's up, Trust One Wolf? Scared version 2!
15 months of Wayne and Howl.
Thank you very much. Knives at Midnight, welcome with the new, brand new Prime sub. Much appreciated. It's been a while. It's good to be back. Did you miss me? Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you missed me, because I'm here. But if you did, well, that's cool. And if you didn't, why not? I mean, these. I'm pretty cool. I'm all right. No problems. Thank you very much. Vasalinator, thank you. Evner Vinko. Andronicus 7, thank you. You have over 100k channel points now, says Latch Croc. One of these days, there will be something you can do with those that isn't summoning demons. I actually found, well, I didn't find it, Mira found it, but Mira recommended a software that lets you implement, like, some very simple channel point
artificial
redemption
intelligence
stuff.
Dungeon the second.
While simple, it's more than just summoning demons, and we all go like, you know that shit don't matter.
6 months.
Yo, Valp with the
raid.
What's up, Valp? Hope you guys had fun playing Battlefield. Subscribe to me, please. Well, the God says, for some reason, I can never watch Wayne streams live. Other streams are fine for me. That's just, I don't know.
10
your
moths.
Computer's weak.
That's so many moths, please.
Your
help
phone
there
isn't
are too
strong
many
enough.
Moths.
Actual demons? I mean, we could make like a little Satan pop up. We could make like, hold on. If you're afraid of the devil, don't look at the screen for a minute.
Subscribe to me, please. Please subscribe to me.
Googling Google image searching Satan might be one of the scariest things you could do.
Subscribe to me, please.
There's not a lot of good pictures here. When you search Satan, it doesn't come up with what you want.
I must save the
I think if I search devil, I'll get what I want.
Subscribe to me, please.
Oh, this song fucking goes. Hot stuff, the little devil. What the fuck?
Subscribe to me, please.
This is the Homestuck devil. Alright, I'm too lazy to download these images, so I'm not gonna show you what I meant. We could summon these.
Subscribe to me, please. Please subscribe to me. Please.
You summon demons and get these. These aren't even what these are called! These are not devil creams. I just realized, what the fuck? Aren't these called devil dogs? Am I getting Berenstain Bears? Am I getting Mandela affected? Those are devil dogs. Drake's has devil dogs. Wait, what the fuck, Lil Debbie?
Jay.
Star Attacker, thank you very much, Jay. There are... What's a ding dong? Hold on. Ding dong. Okay, ding dong is the hostess thing. Wait, those are ding dongs? Hold on. All right, chat, we're gonna have a pre-packaged snack cake discussion really quickly. So these are ding-dongs, apparently. I thought ding-dongs were the little, like, rolls with the spiral of cream.
Wayne, I hope you are eating good today.
Ding-dongs are so bad, most of these are bad. As an adult, I can't eat this shit. What am I thinking of? Ho-hos? Twinkies and ho-hos! It is ho-ho! This shit's so stupid. Wait, what's the Little Debbie equivalent of ho-ho? Ho-ho, Little Debbie.
I've managed to bungle setting up the Christmas lights
anyway. They don't have a Little Debbie. Oh, they do. It's called a Swiss roll. For some reason, the Swiss rolls are downloading it as an HTML file. So I... Oh, wait, and they're called yodels sometimes. What are they called yodels?
Subscribe to me, please.
Oh, yodels are the Drake's variety.
More
these three
I've
companies, the, what? Two of them have to stop. This is too confusing.
Subscribe to me, please.
Good thing I don't eat this shit. Knives at Midnight, thank you very much. We are already at a 527% hype train, probably because I haven't streamed in over a week. Sorry about that. Was very busy with the gnome stuff, and then I kind of went under the weather for a bit. And then Dobie ate some pills that he wasn't supposed
four
to.
4 months.
Which was what canceled my stream plans the other night. He's fine, don't worry. He literally had no side effects. We cleared him with poison control immediately.
When do you plan on getting
but
the
other
Dungeon streams on YouTube?
I'll get to it. Probably, like, I think one of them is just sitting on the YouTube channel waiting to get unlisted. The other one I have to dig up a recording of.
Because
it got muted on Twitch. Ryan Phantom, thank you for the Prime sub, Prime Gaming. Floss Goblin, thank you so much.
If you don't floss your teeth, the Floss Goblin will get you in more sleep. Remember to practice good dental hygiene.
I need to get these fucking snack cakes off the screen. It looks like we're sponsored, but you're absolutely not. Yo, Adriotes, thank you for the Prime sub. I am joined today by... Gurr added me with a picture of devil dogs. Hello, who's here? Who's in the call?
Nearly 1 year.
What?
Wow.
Welcome to the stream.
Can you see for yourself?
We got three guests. Three guests to start, but that's going to change. It's going to be morphing. People are going to be leaving. People are going to be popping in.
AI
who knows who could be in these AI stories, but we are currently joined by Log, Gurr, and Scorpy.
Me,
how are you three doing?
Please subscribe to me. Please.
No answer?
I've been trying to figure out what to do.
How so?
Because, you know, I mean, like, I finished my chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't want to start a new one.
Miraguru Patty.
Thank you, Supernova Dad.
What can I do?
Well, you can hang out on stream with me and play AI Dungeon. You found your answer. Thank you for the sub, Sexual for the Homies. That's a fucking good name. Welcome. Bird Cult, welcome very much. Kiznivers. How are you doing, Scorpy?
I'm feeling good.
16 moths in my house, please help.
You
feel
like
get rid of them.
You feeling like good? You want to tell a tale?
The last time I was on here, we had the Jesus pineapple class.
That couldn't have been the last time. I think you've been on since then.
Oh, John,
I don't remember the last time I was here.
It's 16 months of Wayne.
It's been a long time for me.
I don't think it's been that long for either of you. Thank you, a pissed mace for the tier 1 sub.
It's been a while since one of these.
I feel like you've been on fairly recently. Gurr, you definitely have, and Scorpy, not that long ago.
No, for me, I jumped in like in the last like 20 minutes of the last one you did. That's what it was.
I have become the AI.
Thank you, Ebner Binko, and someone gives it a sub to Little Debbie. Is that official? Do you think that Twitch account is official? Do you think there's an official Little Debbie Twitch?
What's Little Debbie?
It's like a snack cake company.
About to
you know, like
what funny hawk is.
They have that in Canada.
What is Little
well,
Debbie's?
It's probably a host. It's probably just a Twitter for hostess.
Well, no, Twitch. Twitch, not Twitter. Found
Little Debbie clams.
The little Debbie clams.
No, it's this. Look in the fucking Discord.
Oh, Swiss rolls.
Yeah, yeah.
They got a Pillsbury Doughboy YouTube channel.
I just bought a ticket to visit my
family. See, Drake's isn't on the West Coast, so it was good to come back to the East and be able to get Drake's stuff.
Hell yeah, Karen Dross.
I don't know what the fuck Drake is.
Everybody's coming down here.
What? Drake's doesn't make it into Canada?
Everybody's coming down here.
Those look like sailors' rations.
Is I Am Not says, why won't my donation go through? It might just be backed up. Or did it literally not go through? Like, is it getting rejected?
We live in Mulholland.
That would be whack if that's the case. I don't know why
PayPal could be acting up.
Go home.
PayPal or Stripe, we got two options.
It might could.
Hey, I'm going to say this because I feel like if I don't, or if I do at least, it'll inspire us to work harder and to get it ready.
You're going to get canceled if you say it.
I'm not going to get canceled. It's just going to get them excited.
Well, it's not about yesterday.
Wait, you're here. That's right. I can't address the drama while you're here. Shit. The plan fucked up. All right, folks. Gert thinks I'm going to get canceled, but I don't think that's the case.
15 months.
I'm going to say it, and say hopefully we're ready, and we don't have to postpone it.
What should I say?
Within a couple weeks, folks.
Faxmas 2.
Super Boogaloo.
Super Faxmas. 2021 Faxmas. And this is not just a regular Faxmas. Three? No, the first Fax stream was not a Christmas stream.
Faxmas, yeah, that was just Fax
Super
stream.
Faxmas.
Yeah.
And this time, let's just say Santa's gonna have some helpers.
It's not high anymore.
Slump was not a helper. Slump just stood there and I took toys out of his ass.
Right, we got the Mets. Love the Mets, baby.
Do a sick flip when...
There's your donation, see? I'm not about... I can't do a flip. You think I could do a goddamn flip?
I did one. Subscribe to me. It's easy.
What the fuck, 20
How do I simulate a flip? Hold on, watch this shit.
Just jump and lean backwards as hard as you can.
I would just fall down. Check out this flip. Check out this flip. See that? 1 year.
Love to gnome vids.
Brandon would like me to show you.
That was like a that was like an 860 degrees flip.
Asshole.
That's like some Olympic shit.
I'm proud of it.
People train their whole lives to do that kind of flip, but you did it sitting down.
I can do it. I've proven myself to the world.
Do it again, but slower.
Okay. All right, this is for you, as I am not, and Big Man on Campus, you just sucked. Whoa. Subscribe to me, please. This is all in the mind, folks. You don't need any physical skill to do that.
Where's the thud?
You hit the ground hard. There was a little bounce there.
Huh?
I didn't hear a thud.
Huh? Thanks.
Again. Boom. Please. I don't have a soundboard on right now. So what am I supposed to? Joyous Frog, thank you so much. Waiter flip, hell yeah. That's an official, unofficial announcement. We're going to, everyone's coming down to Dallas in the next few weeks. And when it happens, we're going to try to do a
17 months.
And I think you guys are going to enjoy it. I got a few surprises lined up there. This is also the first stream I've done after the Gnome videos release. So I hope you guys, am I wearing a green shirt? Oh, this is a black shirt. I don't know what you're on about. You're more colorblind than me. That's not meant as an insult, girl. That's just the truth. This is,
I know.
If you think this is green, just go see your optometrist. It'd be good for you. What was I saying? Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the Gnome videos. I'm working on the second act, which is proving to be a lot harder than the first one for reasons it's very difficult to get into. But I hope you enjoyed them, and I hope you keep enjoying them, and I hope you keep showing them to your friends and spreading the word, because that hasn't quite caught onto the algorithm or anything yet. But I am happy with the reception.
Love the gnome, baby.
Go on those videos and just comment. I love this gnome so much; he's not annoying.
Ring the bell.
Which is the number one criticism that I've been getting to the gnome videos. People are just like, "Damn, this gnome is annoying." Dislike, and it's like, yeah. Yeah, he is. That's the whole. That's like the basis of the series. Is that this?
Damn,
no,
this orange is
this
annoying.
No.
Dislike.
I did see a comparison that saying this series is just the annoying orange, and I was a little unhappy about that. I'll be real. That's
my god.
That hurts a bit.
I think you should. Oh my god. I think you should go.
Knife.
I think you should go on the videos and comment, did Wayne Radio TV disappear? It's been a week. There's no new video. Where did he disappear? Is he gone?
Next one's coming in 8 months. I'm taking my time. Hold on.
I realized I got a comment like that on Gather You Power.
Binging on 7 bananas.
Really?
Because I checked. I checked.
Two videos will be out Wayne in a week.
Binging.
Wayne binging. Usually it takes me a month. Wayne but this time it was a month Wayne and a half because I was Wayne going binging. Slow.
Wayne
and I checked the previous chapter just a few moments ago, and I saw like a string of comments from the same person. That was just, oh, what happened to the creator? Did they go? Are they gone? What happened? But like, hold on. Let me find the exact dates. Let me find the time frame.
By the way. Here's the code in the Discord for joining the AI Dungeon session. So today, Senor Bob, thank you very much. I want to take a break from the commitment of every single time we do an AI Dungeon stream, starting with a fantasy story. Because I feel like, personally, starting with a fantasy story, sometimes you get a little bit of a dud. I feel like our most unremarkable AI Dungeon stories have been some of the ones with the fantasy stories. Of course, there are some classic moments that tie to those fantasy stories, but I say today we just do the custom, or we do like the offshoots that aren't fantasy. But for the very first story, for some reason, when I thought about AI Dungeon stories today, the very first story that I wanted to do is a fast food story. I was thinking about the Hamburger Belt McDonald's bit that happened, and I was like, why don't we do a story where us four are working at a fast food place? Like a made up fast food place. Or should it be something we make up, or should it be like McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's.
Hey, what's
it should
a
just
name
be
for
McDonald's.
I want to work at Burger King.
You want to work at Burger King?
Okay, we've done McDonald's, so we can do Burger King now.
All right, so it's a bright and early Wednesday morning as you pull into the Burger King parking lot. You and your friends all work part-time gigs at the Greasy Burger Bar. Classic burger.
Zebra Cakes are the best TBA.
What are you talking about?
Listen, I'm not a writer. When I write, it takes me like 10 revisions to make it not sound like a alien.
Like a child wrote it.
No, an alien. At the Greasy
alien child.
Bar.
Snacks change their name
you
to blend
all
into their
love Burger King so much. You are the most dedicated teenage employees.
Are you the Burger King recruiter saying this?
How are you doing?
No,
okay.
This is just the
doing
start of the
nice.
Story. You just gotta give Why? It. You gotta give it lore. You are the most dedicated teenage employees that the manager has ever hired. But Burger King is not doing so hot. McDonald's dominates this town. And it's your dream to make this Burger King shine and rise above the clown's tyranny.
Okay. It's All gonna right. be really confused with this.
Actually, maybe I shouldn't write Rise Above the Clown's Tyranny because it's gonna think it's like a fantasy story about an
it's
evil
gonna,
clown.
It's gonna, exactly.
And rise above the stigma that Burger King stinks and McDonald's rules.
Oh, yeah, exactly. There you go.
I'm hungry for a McChicken McSloppy Jerky.
Alright, there we go.
Game on!
What?
Game on.
What the fuck that? Is Westy E. Sleppy? What the fuck does that mean?
Westy's my character, but that's not what I typed. Wait
the
a second!
It's 20
what the fuck?
What happened?
What the fuck? Wakey Wakey Eggs and Bakey Slug a Bend. What the fuck?
Are you on, like, dummy
go?
Mode?
Where Jay. My
what
story
happened?
Go? That was my whole story! It took it away! What the fuck?
Westy E. Sleepy.
Hold on. You. Alright, we gotta type it again. You and your friends all work.
7
hey, while you're typing that.
So close
what?
To
log
the sleepy.
Done. Don't log, type how anything, long? It's gonna fuck everything up. I don't know what Westy E. Sleepy is.
How long was it between your comics when someone made that comment?
Ryan Phantom, thank you very much. Oh, by the way, chat, we are gonna do media shares. I'm gonna get them started after the story's going.
It was they posted it 6 days ago, so it was like a week after a month.
Oh, what was spooky 13 months.
That's the time period where I'm declared dead.
Damn, impatient. Meanwhile, I keep checking on Prequel, the comic, and it's been almost a full year since the last chapter.
zebra cake.
Well, someone said take it off due. You're on due right now.
Well, that shouldn't matter, is the thing. Like, because that's... Whenever you start a custom story, the first thing you enter is the story prompt. That's never an issue. And also, even if I did leave it undo, why would it change the whole story into Westy E. Sleppy? I didn't type anything remotely like that.
Have you thought about just going with that one and seeing what happens?
I did see what happens, Westy and it said something Sleppy. About Wessel slurging over in the back. It was like, it was some weird shit. Honestly, it would be a fun experiment to see what AI Dungeon does when you, like, just start with some absolute bullshit. Okay, let's keep typing this. Pull into the lot of the Burger King.
I changed my name.
You love your job, and you give it your all,
LGBT peeps in
despite
the way
only being a teenage part-time employee. You are the star of this Burger King.
Wait. You're writing that like it's only one person.
Who cares? It figures it out. It's not that
just
picky.
Replace all the U's with we's. We love our job.
You are all the stars
we
of
are
this
a teenage
Burger
employee.
King. Of this Burger King, your manager thinks you are insane because you love Burger King so much.
Yeah.
Your dedication is unreal, but in this town,
they have to play Sonic Heroes.
McDonald's rules, and your mission is to show the small town. Give me a name. Give me a small town name.
Springfield.
That's no. I want an original story. Springfield.
Parkersville.
Parkersville.
Big
we'll
city.
Go with that. Big city.
the small town of Big City.
It's to show the small town. The small
big city's town.
Of Big City's town.
GM underscore Big City.
That Burger King is more than meets the eye. It's time to start the day of fast
time
food.
To duel.
Alright, let's hope that doesn't. What the fuck?
Nice smile.
Ooh, and your friends.
Hold on a second.
Ooh, and your friends.
We're gonna delete all this.
Finally caught in AI Dungeon Sims talk. I've watched all your VODs for it and can't wait to see the chaos unfold.
Or two roll.
Hell yeah. Alright, it's time to start the day of fast food. The morning rush went well and you finally received a breather around noon. You enter the back room of the kitchen and grab a small cup from the stack, filling it with ice and soda from the machine. Alright, so for the turn order, let's go Gerlog, Scorpy, then me. I'm gonna get media shirt set up really quick. Yes, Ger, you're up first. So it's around noon, so we've skipped the breakfast rush. Noon, it's time for the lunch rush. Okay, so let's get media shares open here. Don't donate yet, of course. That's very important that you don't do that. We're going to open requests. We are going to go over to media shares plus and enable media shares.
Hello, smile.
Enable autoplay. Okay, so media shares should be active. Remember, if you want to do media shares, it's a $5 donation. First come, first serve. However, as we get later into the stream, we might shuffle the playlist a bit. Oh, God. Oh god, that's loud. Hold on, folks. Alright, there we go. Alright, yeah, media shares are working. They're coming on in. Thank you for our first media share for the Cho Annie Key Sexy Dynamite song. Alright, and with that, I'm gonna mute alerts. If the queue seems to, like, completely fill up, I am going to close it, but I will let you know when that happens.
Alright, let's see.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Begin our tale. Oh, my phone's going crazy.
Smelly Joe runs out and yells to all the other employees, I know how we can best be the best. We need to install a GameCube for the kids. A GameCube? What kind of joint has a GameCube? This is a family restaurant, not a game center.
Why did the story just answer
that?
You? No one's saying
that.
Why
is
it's just
story
like the story.
Talking to us.
Yeah,
I
let me retry
that just because it's a little weird. This AI dungeon. Okay, there we go.
Okay, you hear a lot of.
Oh my god, what the
fuck?
What? That's not. That wasn't even like actually offensive. That was just weird. What the fuck?
Yeah, I mean, I just don't know where it took that.
Where
from.
Where did it get that from?
All right, you look at your coworkers.
GameCube's a racist console.
All right, you look at your coworkers. There's an old man who works the grill and cleans up after everyone in the back of the kitchen. Joe, I think you're on thin ice.
What the fuck? I thought we were supposed to be the best employees. Hold on. I'm going to let you answer him. before the next turn goes.
What? Get fucked. You don't even work here.
It's just introducing all these characters.
Nope, fuck you. Reroll.
Wait, what did it do?
He was rubbing his stomach.
What? Sorry. Bob's not here. We can't do that.
Yo, give me $20. Thank you for the $20.
The cashier in a not so nice tone says, you should work here then. What? The AI dungeon is like beefing it.
It's being strange right now. Dynamite.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good. Problem. That's good. What do you can keep that.
Yeah, that's the problem. So what do you think the manager would say when I tell him you called me a dumb son of a bitching motherfucker?
Fucker.
Don't do
mother,
it. Motherfucker.
All right, Log, your turn.
Dumb son of a bitching motherfucker.
Motherfucker.
Gun dealer, we just started. Welcome.
I would like to buy a gun.
Thank you, Nekonyata. Media share is kind of quiet. I mean, it should be a little quiet. We don't want it to overpower our voices.
I just got an idea. While Log is typing out his...
No, this is the average volume.
There it is.
Garth ignores the squabble. He is busy toiling over the ketchup bucket, cleaning off all of the mysterious goop on the packets. Do you think that the manager will be able to stop us if we set up shop in the lunch area and sell our own brand of ketchup packets?
What?
No. I think so.
I thought we were trying to like uplift Burger King, and now we're like we're doing under the table business. I like that plot line though.
I got something ready. I got something ready for the next time someone swears, like next time they say son of a bitching motherfucker.
Okay.
So who?
Who's
I
there?
Wish it said who was talking in those quotes, but
you kind of just have to imply it when it does that.
Yeah,
just kind of figure it out.
See, that was a conversation with three people in it, started by Garth, and then two other people reply.
Is it gonna get stuck in a loop of like the only thing it generates is dialogue from nobody?
I mean, I could break that by doing
a story.
Wait, yeah. I'm gonna break this right now.
Yeah, start break it early.
You never see me so clean shaven. I'm recovering from a full shave. It'll be back eventually.
Recovering? It was an injury.
It is an injury. I'm not meant to be this clean shaven.
I feel that.
It's like, there's enough stubble now where it looks fine, I guess.
Looks better.
I look like a total baby.
Someone said, why did the F word get bleeped? That's Twitch's new guidelines.
Yeah, you can't say
Yeah, so we can't swear.
Girl, I don't have it ready. You're gonna have to help me out, okay? I'm about to swear. What the fuck?
It was like a small one. It petered out.
The system's not very strong. It's pretty sh**.
Wait, do that again.
Oh, what the fuck?
It doesn't work for anyone else but me.
So good.
I don't know what to tell you. This sucks.
Oh man. I don't give a fuck.
Girl, what the fuck? How are you fuck?
Girl, did you fuck my chicken?
What? Ah.
Whose turn is it?
It's my turn. It's my turn. What? Oh, fuck. Fuck.
Was Smelly Joe fucking the chicken again? What's...
Oh, no. Fucking chicken.
You calling my chicken? Boop.
Fuck.
For those who don't know what that is, what is that? Just Three Boys?
Twitch is censoring me specifically, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I have to do it.
Folks, there's already so many media shares in the queue. I'm going to lock it up for a bit. I'll let you know when I open it again. Thank you to everybody who's donated so far.
But
yeah, that's.
I'll return.
I will open them if it seems like the list is going down. I'll let you know.
What the fuck? Oh yeah, I think it isn't. I think I'm just gonna do a story one. I think it's broken.
You definitely need to do a story one. It like this story started all whacked up.
Started whack.
It did. It started with Trog. Are you here now?
Hi.
Hi. Welcome to the stream, Trog. This story was so fucking weird. AI Dungeon did the weirdest thing it's ever done, where I did a custom prompt, I typed in the whole story, and when I hit enter, it just deleted it and replaced it with Westy Asleppy. That's just all
Westy Asleppy.
And that wasn't like that wasn't remotely close to what I typed. It didn't make any sense.
That's great.
It is pretty good. What's that translate to? Yeah, start that chant. Ah, fuck yeah.
It fucking ignored the story.
Ooh, it's sleppy. Is that Westy who is sleppy?
Ignored the story, but what does your prompt even mean?
What the fuck? Okay, I'll remove that from it.
Who is sleppy? Oh, man.
Should I just hit enter?
There we go.
The manager comes over and addresses you and the other employees. I'm hitting enter again.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
Nothing, I guess. Oh.
I have an announcement to make. His hair is standing on end and his face is ghost white. We are selling a brand of ketchup packets that isn't one we usually use. There were complications with the other owner.
Uh-oh.
Other owner of what?
What does that mean? And why is he scared? All right, whose log went, so it's Scorpy's turn?
No, it's your
Scorpy
turn.
Went.
I did a story to break the dialogue.
Yeah.
Up.
Yeah.
That ketchup is blood.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Good luck, man. Good luck being consistent on that.
Oh fuck.
Concerned, Westy asks his boss why he's so scared about the ketchup packets being different. Son, he begins, there's a reason I buy pre-made ketchup packets. Now hush. No one dares to ask him another question. Hold on, I'm going to delete you drive home because that doesn't...
Like, yeah, it starts moving on.
All right, so no more questions asked about the ketchup. A mystery has been proposed.
All right, is it my turn?
Yes. What is the opposite of a pre-made ketchup packet? Like, we fill our own?
Post-made.
We fill them?
Custom ketchup.
None of that Heinz shit.
Thanks, Leshy.
Don't put it in front of me unless it's purple!
Thank you, young...
If I do...
Sarkanoth?
If I do a story and then, like, leave it open-ended, it fills it, right?
Yes. Yes, it will finish your sentence. Which creates some interesting stuff.
Now wait till it generates you. Okay, Smelly Joe grabs one of the ketchup packets and realizes what's wrong. This isn't ketchup. It's some kind of vile liquid that stains everything it touches. He immediately throws the packet on the ground and flees the scene. What the hell is this stuff, he asks.
Ketchup does that. Ketchup stains most things.
It does.
Maybe Smelly Joe doesn't know what ketchup is.
What the hell is this stuff?
I see you're doing the Tony Zaret type censoring. Guys, you knew this was a fast food story and you went ahead and donated for Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Boss Music.
Yeah, I'm Tony Zaret starring the hog.
You didn't even get the first word out.
The hog.
There we go. Oh yeah, folks, we have a new emote, courtesy of UFO Elegy. I still don't really know how to pronounce your name, so apologies there. But they provided us with the new Wayner Go Chimp animated emote. It did replace the Gus Fring Hank emote, but like no one earnestly used that, so I think you guys are fine with that.
I've been saying UFOlogy.
UFOlogy? Maybe that's what it is.
Damn, look at that fucking chimp go.
It's a good emote. I could swap Imagine back in place of the Wayner Ultimate Human one, because we already have that as a still emote. I wish you could have more than 5 GIF emotes.
Here's a complimentary GIF.
Garth puts his plan into action. In the corner booth of the establishment, he sets up his wares. Garth's custom chup, 50 cents per packet. There's a weird taste to this, Westy says. Yeah, it tastes like sadness. It's a sad taste, isn't it? Maybe I could get used to it.
I'm gonna press enter.
Suddenly, an elderly Midwestern couple stumble into the establishment. They are looking for something to liven up their day. They think they found it in a nice cup of chup.
A cup of chup.
That's awesome. I think we've got the story on track, folks.
All right.
Scorpy's
turn.
Hey, taxidermy. Thanks for the sub.
I could go for a nice cup of chup.
A nice cup of chup. When I was a kid, I used to have nightmares about big buckets of ketchup and like having to eat them.
What?
Yeah, it was because of that SpongeBob episode where he puts the... Remember where he puts the ketchup in the sundae?
Yeah. That affected you that badly?
It wasn't like nightmares in the sense where I'd wake up screaming, but I would just have like uncomfortable dreams where there would just be a lot of ketchup and I'd have to eat it.
That's really fucking funny.
SpongeBob was powerful.
Dorsey's powerless. I like that. What the hell?
Okay. Dorsey's powerless to the chup and downs about 20 cups in one go. After the elderly couple places their order, Dorsey downs the entire contents of the cup. What the hell did you put into that, his wife asks. My own special recipe. Uh-oh. What? No, it's not me. Uh-oh.
Sorry, there's a bad word in
what
there.
What did you put into that? His wife asked. I added water. What? It tasted like watered down gasoline and sadness. Maybe it was the cup that tasted that way. Hey, can I have some of yours? Yes, but I hate to see you consume their swill.
Who is even talking anymore?
I don't really know who's talking anymore. I think it might be stuck in another, like...
Yeah, dialogue loop. This is bullshit.
Westy takes the initiative and starts whipping up the most delicious cup of chup for these beautiful elders. She slips the taste of sadness into them like a pro, and the couple sucks it up. In the most Midwestern accent you've ever heard, the husband says to his wife, Mabel, this is delicious chup. We gotta remember this place. What's a Midwestern accent exactly?
I was just trying to think of that. Is that like...
Well, definitely don't ask me. I don't know what's in the Midwest.
You didn't do the... I don't know how to do it.
We gotta remember Canadian? This place.
Yeah, I guess that
Oh, yeah, be. I was like, Mabel, this is delicious chop. We gotta remember this place. Over there.
Chup.
The chup is a hit, and you have 3 new regular customers. You only have 1 customer left to convert over to the dark side of sadness, Mr. Reynolds.
What?
He is the most loyal customer, so you'll really need to wow him with some delicious chup. All right, Gerds, your turn.
Oh, shit.
I like how to just like assume that chup is a Midwestern dish, so that's where this is taking place. I feel like that's the reason it's specifically Midwestern, is because of the chup. It sounds Midwestern. Frank Reynolds from Always Sunny? I don't think it said Frank. What are you doing to that poor man? We're giving him ketchup. Chuck. Somebody asked if they removed the prompt that says someone is typing. They did. I don't know why.
Yeah, that is weird. All right. Smelly Joe adds his secret smelly sauce into the chup to really put the finishing touch on this succulent sauce. The moment these Midwestern motherfuckers taste it, they begin to salivate. My, this is wonderful. What is it, my dear? Asked the old man. Just a cup of chup.
I love this romanticized fast food place where every employee has their own secret ingredient. Like, that could ever work or happen.
It's the old style fast food.
Yeah.
I'm putting mustard in the chicken.
Break a cup of chop.
Is it my turn or are you doing something?
Oh, oh yeah, I'm done.
I can put up a side stream of the media shares so y'all can hear them. I forgot that I have that on.
Oh! Yeah, this is Good Burger.
No, it's Burger King.
Welcome to Good Burger Home.
Oh, welcome to Burger King, home of the Whopper.
Welcome to Good Burger, home of the Good Burger.
Can I take your order?
Roblox SCP OST?
Alright, well...
Mr. Lovely, Fries!
Lovely characters being introduced, but that doesn't work.
Mr. Fries and Mr. Slauson?
We can reincorporate Mr. Fries later.
Well, that's nothing. Alright, well, it's relevant. Alright, Garth gets agitated that his coworkers are interfering with his side business. Guys, I'm running a business here. Mind your own damned business.
Alright. Holy shit.
Good
try. I think you're a bit slow there. We're just trying to help. You're hindering my business. You're being a square. Let's hit enter. I would like a large soda. The manager, go ask him to make that man be quiet.
That's the manager that wants the soda.
Make me a large soda as well, and we'll call it even. You don't know what the hell just happened, but Garth is in the middle of shouting his last statement when the man slaps him across the face. You're a dumb motherfucker.
It's censoring it. Again.
You're a dumb motherfucker.
Oh, fuck. Whose turn is it?
Scorpy.
My turn.
Hello, Thrilly.
Oh, my God. Large Sodar.
Large Sodar.
That's so fucking funny.
Hopefully this isn't too much for AI Dungeon.
Oh my god!
What do we say? Do we keep that? I feel like
yes. We keep it.
Yeah, let's keep that. Okay, okay. Dorsey begins to chuck up Chup, but he tries to hide it in front of Mr. Reynolds, who is very important. Gross. He begins preparing one large sodar. After the manager does his best to hide his Chup behind his back, Dorsey begins to projectile vomit Chup into a paper cup. He then fumbles around and pours it into Mr. Reynolds' mouth. But I want to press enter on this and see what happens.
Yeah, sure.
I accidentally added some of the sauce, he says in a soft voice. You added some sauce?
Oh my god. Hit enter again.
No, I'm typing something.
Oh.
You added some sauce.
Oh my god, dude.
Westy stares Dorsey dead in the eyes. What kind of sauce, Dorsey? What kind of sauce? The sadness. I put in some sadness. All of a sudden, Mr. Reynolds starts to weep. This is one of those days where everything you love is being taken away from you and there'd be nothing you could do about it.
Oh my god. My turn?
Cheer up, Mr. Reynolds. He's our most valuable customer. It is your turn.
All right.
Yeah, Mr. Reynolds is important. We can't fuck up.
We already did fuck up.
I don't know. We still haven't heard if Mr. Reynolds liked it or not.
That's true. It was just Chup.
A little Chup with sauce.
Somehow this AI links Burger King with sadness. I think it's not that far off.
Yeah. Personally. I agree. All right, here we go. Smelly Joe cheers up Mr. Reynolds. Don't worry, it's just up, Chup. You'll feel better soon. Mr. Reynolds wipes his tears and smiles. That's a nice mug you have there. I'm glad you like it. Here's the last of the cups.
There we go.
I gave him a cup, I guess. Yeah, there you go. Am I reading this?
Yeah, you can read it.
Alright, Smelly Joe gives him the mug. Westy comes over with a tray of drinks and sets it in front of the man. I'll be back in a little bit to see if there's anything else you need, sir.
Okay.
He got his large sodar. Multiple, it sounds like.
He did.
Multiple large sodar.
Alright, let me add one more thing here. Hold on.
Burger King is the Sbarro of burger places? Is that true? I feel like the energies are distinctly different.
Okay, I guess I'm saying it. Mr. Reynolds is loving his large stone heart.
Hold on, I'm re-rolling that. That's not interesting.
I am. As a matter of fact, I've never had one this large before. I'm partial to having the sauce in the cup myself. Thanks for setting this up, man.
Hell yeah. He loves it.
Smelly Joe saves the day.
He's not even weirded out by you talking in like a weird referential manner.
Mr. Reynolds is loving his large sodars.
I've never had a soda this large before.
With the sauce. Everything in this Burger King gets the sauce.
All right, you're next up. You're getting the sauce.
I accidentally put sauce in it.
The sadness.
You put sauce in it?
Still cracking up over large sodar.
Yeah, large sodar.
Yeah, you're just like, time recognator. We're barely just starting.
We're gonna have a f***ing good time.
Oh, fuck. Woo. Yeah.
Yeah, f***. Yeah.
What? It skipped half of what I wrote.
is it not when you're tired of creating the biggest cups in the world?
All right, hold on. Let me.
That looks good as is.
What happened?
Maybe another Westy sleppy moment.
AI Dungeon's like eating text like today, I guess.
Well, whatever. I guess I'll just not write it again. All right, Garp is. I'll just say it myself because I remember it. While the current situation seems to have resolved with a happy ending, Garth is struck with inspiration for a new business opportunity, creating the biggest cups in the world. I can just see myself creating the biggest cups in the world. You're a dumb motherfucker.
Damn!
Weston says, I will be the biggest cup manufacturer in the world. I have $1 million. All right, I'm going to hit enter. You're an idiot. Wait. Everyone knows cups are for drinking out of. Enter.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Something is happening to Mr. Reynolds.
Oh my god, what's happening?
Everyone's wrong. I agree. I'd like to see you make. I imagine this is a conversation that's happening while Mr. Reynolds is transforming the back. I'll make a fortune. I'll hire you.
He's getting really small. I'm shrinking.
You're an idiot, what he says.
I'm gonna be crushed by a giant cup.
Mister. I'll just remove that mister.
Scorpion, you're up. Damn.
I'm gonna be crushed by a giant cup!
Oh, this is awesome. What the fuck? What does that mean?
I don't. How could he be sitting in something that he's about to get crushed by? I might reroll that.
That doesn't make sense.
That's nothing.
Feel free to reroll as many times as you wish.
I'll keep that. All right, Dorsey dives for the cup, trying to save Mr. Reynolds, who is now small. The cup is too late. Dorsey is too late. The cup crushes Dorsey. Wait, no, I'm dead. Oh, fuck. I don't want
to
be dead.
Hold on, we'll change that to Mr. Reynolds, because that's what it meant, okay. I think.
Yeah.
The cup is too late. The cup is too late.
The cup crushes Mr. Reynolds to tiny bits, and he is gone. The cup is too late. The cup is too late. What happened? I want to press out down this to see.
The cup is too late. That's what happened.
Yeah, I wonder. Up in this drink and then give it to someone and shrink them and then kill them? How could you?
Typical Burger King. Cat, this is why we don't go to Burger King. Why is the large soda served in Mr. Manager's cup?
Because Mr. Reynolds liked that cup.
I really like
He's
your
our most important
cup.
Customer.
Can you serve it in his?
The creature formerly known as Dorsey grabs the mug and laps up the tiny pieces of Mr. Reynolds. A change is beginning. A black pulsing shape is revealed in the bottom of the mug, and it zips up and grows a pair of massive wings in an instant. The creature is now a black dragon.
What?
Just kidding, our fantasy story.
Did you not like that? You want to try again?
I just don't get it.
You don't get it?
Because it's not a change in Dorsey.
Yeah, that's true. I'm gonna give it another go.
That's something. That's like Mr. Reynolds being revived.
All right, you wake up. That's no. Sorry, that was funny, but I gotta reroll it. Something went wrong.
Did you do it again?
It did.
Reroll again.
Ah, pancakes and bacon.
Wait, it like kept it.
Good morning, sleepyhead.
There we go. All right. Fuck off.
No, that's fine. That's what.
No,
what
I want
says.
More. I want more. Fuck you! Fuck off. What? I get enough?
What?
Alright, we're keeping that. Wet. This ranch. You. I.
Love is blooming. Blooming.
I need to get back to work. I have a meeting with the owner of this place, Mr. Tom. Mr. Manager walks there. This story is kind of just devolved.
No, I think it's fine. I think it's fine. I think we can keep going.
Wet. I love you. I love you too.
Love is blooming.
I need to get back
to work.
All right,
Gary, it's your turn. I think we need to get back to work. I think we need to keep Burger King running.
All right, we're back
for
to
no
work.
One. Not even if Dorsey's a big monster.
All right, let's get this back on track. Now that... All right, let me...
What?
Didn't you just take your turn?
Yeah, but I feel like this needs to get put back on track before we can really do anything.
Wait, that was Gary's turn?
Yeah.
I thought that was Scorpy's turn getting wrapped up.
No, that was me.
I didn't do that.
Oh.
I'll just
my
do
turn
this
was the
so
cup is
get
too
back
late.
On track. I got extra long turn. Sorry. What?
Reroll that shit. Reroll that shit.
Oh, and it's not called Coffee Boy. One.
What?
I vote reroll.
Got one more reroll here. Okay, we should finish these cups and get out of here. This place is an ecological disaster area. Wait, why does this matter so much to us? Why do we care about this job? Why do we care about Burger King?
Because we love Burger King.
All right, someone then Log's gonna have to talk about loving Burger King.
Log can do whatever he wants.
If that's what, yeah, Log is gonna say if Log chooses such. I'm not gonna tell him what the f*** to do.
Thank you, Sentry CX, for the sub.
Yo, what's this music?
Love and Rockets, it says. Who ripped 20C?
I like this.
The lunch rush has begun. A wall of customers has formed in the Burger King, blocking all exits. The line stretches all the way to the door of the building. There's no way out. You're going to have to serve your time.
Mr.
Tom
to
looks around
shit.
And gestures towards the kitchen.
Yeah!
Alright.
I could use a dream or a genie or a wish. Much simpler than this. Cause after all the party and smashing and crashing, and all the glitz and the glam and the fashion, and all the pandemonium and all the madness.
This music has me mad distracted.
It's pretty damn good.
And it's Scorpy's turn, so it's okay.
Right. Yo, the way your goat chip matches the beat. Well, it's not DMCA. Ah, it's fine. I've been more lax about that lately. The VOD gets muted on here, it goes up on YouTube, and it's fine on YouTube. The only thing I'll be really anal about that with is, like, if like, you donate for, like, just an Imagine Dragons song, I'm not gonna let that play. But this would actually be valid as a cover. I messed a little bit with that on YouTube, and, like,
that's true.
It is fair.
What? I have to re-roll that. He is definitely dead.
bacon right, Burger Gerd, King.
Read it.
All right, fuck it. Fuck it. All right, Dorsey quickly runs to the kitchen and makes 5 bacon Burger King meals, piping hot and ready for the swarm of customers. Bacon, yum! You rush into the kitchen and begin to throw the food onto paper towels and into bowls after press enter.
I hit enter.
The bacon falls glistening onto paper towels. The cheese congeals into gooey straight. Oh, sorry, I got a pop-up. How's the AI doing?
Keep reading.
The cheese congeals into gooey strings on the sides of the giant meat slab you call a burger. The hash browns begin to ooze a strange yellow liquid all over the place. Dorsey, what are you doing? There's no time for... But Dorsey is no longer Dorsey. He's become the creature you serve.
The creature you serve.
It's the Burger King.
You are the Burger King.
I also love the idea of serving shit at Burger King off from paper towels. Like, not even fucking... Here's your bacon on
Westy
a paper
does not
towel.
Dare getting, Westy does not dare getting in Dorsey's way as it prepares the bacon Burger King meals with paper towels. Not up to code. You quickly stop thinking about the bacon and get to work. The hash browns are oozing a strange yellow fluid all over the place. Westy, do something! Westy and you throw paper towels at the oozing mass of food. I'm gonna hit enter.
Wesley, do something.
After a whole bunch of frantic wiping, everything looks the way it's supposed to. You let the ooze spread to wet all the food evenly, and then you carry it out to the customers. The food is growing!
Nice.
Westy, we need more food! Westy and you throw as much food as you can on the table. Still, it's not enough. The mass of food is growing out of control.
Oh,
wait,
shit.
There's not enough food, but the food is growing out of control.
Alright, Gerd, it's your turn. Thank you, Hot Potato.
Oh boy, what the fuck do I do with this? I don't know. I'm gonna just do this and see what happens.
Just keep making burgers.
Smelly Joe says, help! You turn to see the restaurant's namesake, Smelly Joe, pointing towards... We're not at Smelly Joe's. Pointing towards the ceiling. Over there! Westy and you turn around to see hanging from the ceiling a large hairy Spider-Man.
Awesome. Keep it.
Awesome. All right, I'm hitting enter. I want to see what happens. What happens with the large hairy Spider-Man?
That could be Dorsey.
Gross! Kill it! What? Kill it! You and Westy grab spoons and begin violently stabbing the monstrous Spider-Man.
What the fuck going on in Burger King, bro? What the fuck? Alright, Log, your turn.
Wait, your turn. You have fun. You should tame the monstrous Spider-Man.
It's like it's a man, and our first instinct is to kill it. It's like a person.
Well, you told me to kill it.
I don't know.
I went gross, and you went kill it.
Gross. Huh?
Kill it.
I think you said kill it.
Okay, you can interpret it however you want.
It's true, actually. It'll never be known whether or not Westy or Smelly Joe premeditated the murder.
Garth is in charge of the cash register. He is taking order after order, but the Spider-Man reaches the front of the line and gives him a goo dollar, asking for change. Goo dollar, eh? Westy drops the spoon on the floor. It clings to the linoleum. What's a goo dollar? An alien currency. Now what shall I make first? A loud shriek from the kitchen cuts through the air. It sounds like Dorsey. A gurgling noise drowns everything out for a second, and then silence. Dork?
Dork?
Dork or Dorse? Either one sounds Dorse? Wrong. Alright, it's setting up for Scorpy's turn. That's perfect timing. I think you saved both.
Dork.
Dork?
Dork!
Remember when the gnome called me a dork and I thought it said Turk?
Yes, I still don't know how the fuck.
I don't know. Editing around that moment was so awkward for me.
Legit? Well, I rushed
30 seconds of us talking about it saying Turk.
Yeah, I rushed so hard to get them to be like, what are you talking about? Dork, dork.
No. No, I'm going to redo it.
What?
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 Yeah. Let's keep it going. What?
Well, no,
that's
no,
interesting.
No.
I want to see what no. that was.
Did you just eviscerate him?
I guess so. All right. Dorsey runs out and eats the large hairy Spider-Man. Dorsey, I'm going to be sick, Westy says. You're too stunned to say anything. The entire front of the restaurant is now filled with the giant Spider-Man.
Go ahead, Scorpy.
Dorsey fills its mouth with the monster. What? What? Food! The spider monster emits a horrible shriek that sends Westy and you jumping into the air.
I just wanted to run a Burger King, man.
Westy says, Burger King stops for no monster and begins to grill up the signature dish, a Whopper. There is a portly old man in suspenders waiting for the Whopper. He is licking his chops. Westy prepares the Whopper, grilling it to perfection. The Spider-Man takes a few steps forward. It's walking on human legs now, growing... No. Westy... Dorsey ate the spider. Westinghouse Superior Whopper! The old man grabs the burger and begins to chow down. The monster's gaze shifts from you to the portly gentleman in suspenders. Oh, please don't eat him. He's just a customer. He's just a customer, Dorsey.
The food chain. All in one establishment.
I like that, like, Westy's Whopper is so good, it earned, like, its own special name in that moment.
You gotta read it, Wayne.
Look at that magnificent bulge in his pants, the mold man says, licking his lips. I'm not eating that thing. It's a, you know. Who's he talking about, though? Like, I don't know what he's talking about. I'm gonna re-roll that.
Yeah,
Mr.
I got
Reynolds.
It.
I'm going to eat you. Eat them, Westy says.
And he dies.
Straightforward.
The end.
Not the end.
I know.
Dorsey just ate another customer, which I guess is fine.
Alright. Alright, here we go.
Crinkle Main in chat says he the Whopper so good this old man is gonna suck his ding dong. I appreciate that comment.
Suck his ding dong.
That was word for word. I did not miss words there.
Hey, why did he do it twice?
I don't know.
Melly Joe says, I just wanted to run a profitable Burger King, man. The old man's eyes bug out. He screams, you what? Westy swings his arms around the old man's neck and hoists him off the ground.
Why? Well, I want to serve
the old man
him.
Got eaten.
Yeah, you gotta re-roll that, I think. Everyone in chat said SpongeBob fish, yeah.
I was about to say, yeah, exactly the fact that that was, yeah. This was the last straw. You had been waiting for years to strike. Years of plotting and planning. Years of waiting for the perfect opportunity. You decided to do it yourself.
Do what? That's too much art. You've been waiting for years to strike? Like you're gonna kill someone? Or are we gonna go on strike? We could do that.
Hold on.
Thanks, me mixtape.
Smelly Joe freaks it.
Okay.
The customers begin to panic. People begin to run all over the restaurant. The entire restaurant is in a mad panic.
You turn off the sprinklers and watch the ceiling. The ceiling begins to crack.
What is happening?
I'm freaking it.
Freaks it.
All right, log. I wanted this to be a semi-normal story about making burgers. But AI Dungeon can't help itself. It makes a man shrink and then turns someone into a monster for no reason. It doesn't make any sense why Dorsey turned into a monster.
Thank you, Fungus Potion Reminder. I freak it.
The second Burger King falls through the ceiling. It lands on your head. You die. You are now under the giant Spider-Man. The Spider-Man makes eye contact with you. The Spider-Man wins.
The end.
In my head, I'm just imagining Spideris for this person. That's all I can see. Y'all know Spideris.
Mm-mm.
You know Spideris. That was a horrible wink. What the fuck was that? There we go.
Spideris.
Who died? You know Spideris!
I think all of us did.
Oh, Spideris, yeah. Now I'm seeing it. I forgot his name.
The white man spider, yes.
Yeah,
the
that's
James Charles
of a
spider,
bitch.
Yes.
I don't know what the fuck.
I think that was really good dumb, dialogue. Man. Reroll that. It's just ignoring you.
Man.
Baby Universe.
Oh, okay. This might be some sort of redirection. Wait, I'm gonna press enter just to see. Oh, okay. I don't know what this is about. Okay. I'm good with this.
All right, good.
Dorsey turns into a normal person once he enters the second Burger King. He begins to cook up his famous Whopper burger. Dorsey turns back into a human and he notices the mess you've created. What the heck is wrong with you? You scared me half to death. Oh well, I'm sorry. The Spider-Man shrieks again. Dorsey takes a goo dollar from his shirt pocket and throws it at the Spider-Man. I'm glad I remembered goo dollar.
Yeah.
Wesley says, this Burger King is fucked. We gotta start working at the one that fell through the roof instead. Where's Mr. Manager? Spider-Man got him. Wesley looks around for a moment and seems to be daydreaming. We're gonna work at the other Burger King, right? I've never heard of that happening in real life, you remark. Alright, Gergo, I'm keeping that. We work at a new Burger King that fell through the roof. We have no manager,
apparently.
Yeah, everything's
back to normal.
We gotta pick a new manager. Or where's Mr. Tom? He owns the place.
Alright, hold on.
Hey, Scorby, I never got to tell you, I really like your Suck Pens Fall emote. You've sped up that sequence so quickly that every time I hear it, I can't help but hear a whip crack. Because he starts in the middle, and then he goes off to the side, and then he, like, whips down to the ground. I just hear, like, every time it happens. There's, like, a sound effect with it.
I did that because I had to keep the GIF under 60 frames, so I literally cut out chunks of the GIF.
It's just so fast. Who's mine?
That was so funny, but that's not.
Hold on, reroll that. That's also confusing.
Yeah.
It just keeps injecting the Spider-Man shrieks at you over and over.
It's really thinking about this one. Burger King 2 is almost ready for business. You just need a new manager. The crew starts interviews, and the first one is... Oh.
Westy Walker.
You got a whole bio here. Westy
experience
Walker.
Experience running a Burger King.
Sex boy. Experience running a Burger King before. The second is you, age 27. Experience a lifetime spent dreaming.
That's kind of weird. All right, let's... I want to do something.
You're not 27.
The third interviewee is... A large hired pilot sitting at the table to your right.
Okay, man. We get it. You like the Spider-Man.
Did someone kill this freak? I'm sick of the Spider-Man. They're ruining our lives at Burger King. This whole thing pours syrup all over you. Flicks a cigarette at Westy and makes the okay sign with his four right legs. Challenge over, you have been eaten. Oh, shit.
I keep reading. Alright.
Me?
Yeah. Why the syrup?
The fourth interviewee is a Sasquatch. The fifth interviewee is a lizard with a mullet. The sixth interviewee is a large lizard with a mullet. The seventh interviewee is a purple-headed alien with a pencil-thin mustache. The eighth interviewee is a large, hideous monster with a mullet. The ninth interviewee is a large, evil-looking monster with a mullet, pencil-thin mustache. Mullets are in right now. A man dresses a woman with a mullet. The ninth interviewee is a short, bearded man in a green shirt and tie-dye jeans. Alright. What the fuck is that?
That's gotta be Trog.
Is this the interview? Alright, welcome to the story, Cheese Sticks. Read your prompt, Trog.
No, ignore me.
Brock begins to rap his new song. The mullet has a large knife, the pencil thin mustache is sharp as an icicle. I wanna kick your mullet, I wanna kick your teeth out. You better run away or I'll cut. Don't worry, Green Tie Dye Man says. I'll keep my eye on the boss. You, but how can you work at a Burger King? Two of the main characters died. Is it safe to say that we're just fucking around in this story for a while now?
Yeah.
All right, top tens, baby.
I think it's
baby.
Devolved to that point.
Top tens. Top 10 candidates for manager at Burger King 2. Trog, do you want to jack in the AI?
You missed a little bit of dialogue there, Wayne.
What? That was when Picard from Star Trek The Next Generation showed up. Hello, human. What a great looking costume. Do you think this will be approved for the mission? You, Captain, could you stop telling him to call me human? You know everything about Burger King. The bad news is you look like a food-eating animal. Damn. Green Tie-Dye Man, he's really nice and you know his music. The bad news is he's green and he drinks honey.
Green Tie-Dye Man, he's really nice
Here
and
we
you
go.
Know his music. The bad news is he's green and he drinks honey. Three. Captain Pied, he promises to try the burgers and puffs of frying grease. The bad news is Pied only eats with his pod. Four.
What does that mean? We are joined by Robo Chills, who will be helping us create our top 10 lists.
The large Harry Sasquatch, his
on?
Resume includes
oh, yeah,
working at his
there.
Family's Sasquatch restaurant.
Oh, he's a family man. That's nice.
His family's Sasquatch restaurant? What is Sasquatch food?
Nuts and berries.
The nice news is there's lots and lots of Sasquatch food. Five.
Sasquatch.
The mullet man, his resume includes working at a piece of place called Dive. The nice
a
news is
of-
he doesn't really look or sound like a mouth-breathing lunatic. Six. The smart green lizard, his resume includes working at a video store. The nice news is that's it. Seven. The McDonald's cow, his resume
McDonald's.
Includes embracing
McDonald's
the bear
cow.
Paw way of life. The nice news is he really understands applicants. A. The blob, his resume includes playing for Kentucky. The nice news is he's on boiling water. 9. The pencil mustache man, his resume is more of a list of desired Burger King products. The nice news is it's really, really long. 10.
The Ringmaster.
The Ringmaster, his resume is 100 in letter of intent. The nice news is he has been on fire for 500 years.
Nice. All right. Awesome. Someone do the next top 10 list. But, but here's what you have to do. After you type in your top 10 list, hit enter, and then for the first one, type number one, not in all caps. Because that way Chills will do number one, which is what he's supposed to do. No, like number one, the
top
word.
10 reasons to work at Burger King. 1. The money is good. 2. Management has a free willy. 3.
What does that
the
mean?
Food is free. 4. The customers actually tip you. 5. They have a happy meal.
They do 6. Not.
There are mascots, the Burger King, and a creepy old guy who lives in a castle. 7.
The Burger King.
You can drive the famous cheese wheel, only in Switzerland. 8. There's a cold guy working there, Mr. Snow. 9. The two cold guys working there, Mr. Snow and the Michelin Man. 10. You can take a break at the Whopper Volcano.
The Whopper Volcano, huh?
What is that?
Okay,
That's your ass after eating too many Whoppers. Hey, it's
top
10 Rainbow
films
Road.
The Rock has downloaded. Number 1. Alien versus Predator Hoff Battle of the Worlds. Number 2, Space and Voucher Last Resort.
What?
Number 3, Star Wars what? Child
Space
Republic. Number 4, Super Mario Bros. The Super Mario Bros. 2. Number 5, Dragon Age Origins, Witch Hunt. Number 6, Burger King Throne of Ectoplasms. Number 7, The Lord of the Rings, Shuan Ring. Number 8, Pirates of the Caribbean, Stranger Tides. Number 9, The 2. Number 5, Matrix Ship, Matrix Revolutions. Number 6, Close Combatulate, Sing the Ring. Number 7, The Hobbit Art of the Film. Number 8, The Mummy of Them. Matrix Ship, Matrix Reloaded. Number 10, The Hang of Earth Hangovers. The best years of your life. 1. When you were a child, your parents fed you noodles and sweet tea. 2.
That's
you
true.
Never really knew where babies came from. 3. You're pretty sure OJ murdered someone. 4. You could get on a plane, be in a different country, and be home again in less than a day. 5. Teth played music videos. 6. You never worried about finding a wifey hotspot. 7. Reagan was president when you were born. 8.
No,
the
he
biggest
wasn't.
Portable music device was a tape player, and the biggest desktop computer was the size of a TV. 9. The CD was the newest technology. 10. The world has only one moon. 11. The only web you knew about was Spider-Man's enemy. 12.
Well. Spider-Man's enemy.
I got one.
Okay.
Top 10 websites in the year 1999 type for all ages. Okay, we calmed him down.
Yelled at us.
Hold on. I guess this top 10 list was no good because.
Shout out mail.com.
Right. I clearly failed. Someone else do one.
All right. I got it again.
Was one of them mail.com? Like mail,
yeah.
Like M A L E?
Yeah, that was a website.
M-A-I-L.
Top 10 cyber pets for your whole family.
Yeah, yeah.
Number 1.
Yeah?
He's loading. It takes him a second.
Winky the Fuzzy Toy Pop. Number 2, Cheechby the Stinky Toy Dog. Number 3, Snuffy the Sniffy Bunny. Number 4, Scornkle the Scornkle. The Snail. Number 5, Mucky the Good Look Troll. Number 6, Scruffy the Scruffy Dog. Number 7, Mr.
Mr. Blobby.
Mr. Chills.
Blobby the Blobby Thing. Number 8, Dinner the Hungry Hungry He Isotope. Number 9, Bubbles the Gluttonous Green. Number 10, Brody the Bloody Bunny Rabbit. The top 10 ways you might die in a video game.
I like Gubbles the Gluttonous Green.
Well, number 1. Just generated this next list, so let's keep going.
by having an evil woman in a nurse's outfit inject you with everything imaginable, then being blown up when she sets you free.
Everything
Number
imaginable.
Two, by stepping into the path of a Twoden boulder. Number three, by falling 614,890 in feet without a parachute. Number four, by walking into the path of a blue ghoul. Number five, by waiting around long enough to get old and die of natural causes not likely to happen. Number six, by jumping into a pit of fires, one without a roof that could take a while. Number seven, by throwing yourself down a flight of stairs very easy when it happens. Number eight, by... well, you get the idea. Number
Come
nine,
on.
By getting killed by random thugs in a tavern. Number 10, by doing something really stupid and falling down a hole. The top 10 things you don't forget. One,
your
first childhood
friend. Should we keep going with this one, or
do we want to
inject our own? Okay, I'll just hit enter.
I want to see where he goes with this.
It's all normal.
Oh, yeah, I'm kind of bored with this already.
The day you first met your best friend. 3. The name of the city you used to live in as a child. 4. The next door neighbor you used to have a crush on. 5. The day you first met your current boyfriend. 6. What your favorite teacher at school looks like. 7. The name of the hospital you were born in. 8. The last name of the police officer that ticketed you on the way to the airport. 9. What your dad's face looks like, you really forgot this. 10.
What is happening? Did someone type top 10 dances or did it do that?
What the beach you used to visit every summer looks like. The 11 things you need when jumping out of a plane. Number 1, a parachute. Number 2, a working knowledge of when to release said parachute. Top 10 dances you'll never learn. Number 1, the electric slide. Number 2, the grizzly bear. Number 3, the kitten twirl. Number 4, the black bottom. Number 5, the peanut butter cup.
I'm gonna switch this
number
to chills
6, the
type
funky
lists,
chicken.
Because that's what got us great results last time. Is like, It was like top 10 dark mysteries of the Wild West that will give you sleepless
Number
nights.
7, the trombone slide. Number 8, the running man. Number 9, the Roger Rabbit. Number 10, the swim. Misconceptions about the Old West. 1.
Come on. Come on, AI Dungeon. This is crap. Give us the gold. These are not dark mysteries.
The mysteries don't typically have complete resolved
night?
Answers.
This guy died in 1903. Fuck
dude,
that.
Dude, what the fuck? Dude,
all right, here's
seriously.
What
Top 10 dark mysteries of the Wild West that will give you sleepless nights.
That's
He died with his family in Missouri in 1915. Number 4, what happened to Butch Cassidy? He died with his family in Bolivia in 1908.
Read the tale of the scary baby. Chills is having issues tonight. Wait for it. Is he gonna read this? I don't even know. All right, I'll just hit enter. We'll get the next one.
Number 1, the scary baby of Red Rock. The.
The. So scary he can't even say it.
The.
whole town of Red Rock was killed, the only survivor being Joseph McCaffrey, whose wife, heavily pregnant, refused to go to the scheduled evacuation. She gave birth hours before the rest of her family was put to death by horrible ghostly beings. The baby cried blood ever since. The figure of a small child has been seen in and around Red Rock, its cry sounding like a horrible distorted wail, number two the Desdemona vampire sightings. In the late 1800s, a miner named Jasper Daniels claimed his 12-year-old daughter, Desdemona, had been abducted by vampires and turned into one herself. He formed a band of bounty hunters and set out to track her down. Almost 40 men joined the band, and all but three perished during the journey. The last three were killed by their Onyelfo Springs when they returned, and it's said that the three that returned were indeed creatures, prowling the town and looking for fresh blood. Desdemona herself is thought to be the ultimate source of all vampire myths in Idaho.
Okay, so for number three, let's give it a title that it can't turn into a normal story. Like, something fucking, like, out of left field. Anyone have any ideas?
The Impish Bastard of France.
There we go. That works too.
Number three, Diddy Kong's Haunted Peanut Gun. In the mid-1900s, a young boy by the name of Diddy Kong found a strange metal box in the woods. The box was engraved with strange symbols and engravings. The boy took the box home and cracked it open with a hammer. A horrific ghostly being burst out of the box and immediately possessed his gun, turning it into a pin half his talisman. When the boy went hunting with the talisman, his prey would drop dead of a strange ghoul fever within 12 hours. It's thought that this talisman is the root of the werewolf and zombie myths in Georgia.
Okay, that was good.
Scary.
Number four. The Impish Bastard of France and his wet woes.
Oh.
Well, we're gonna get some.
No, it'll be fine. Might be a little
Number
soggy.
Four, the Impish Bastard of France and his wet woes.
Wet woes?
In the late 1800s, a miner caught in a horrific mine accident stumbled into town, rambling madly about imps and demons. He claimed that the underground creatures led him deeper into the earth, into a lake of fire. He was the only one to escape the inferno, and ever since, sightings of mischievous imp-like creatures, most notably an enormous little red guy, have been reported in various towns in Idaho, the fifth dark mystery of the Wild West is.
Injecting the word imp was, like, too standard for it. We need more, like, Diddy Kong's Haunted Peanut Gun.
All right, hold on.
I'll try another Diddy Kong.
Let me do
another
one.
Another Diddy Kong story? No, cheese stick.
Cheese stick says number five, Sticky Stupid Sam's Haunted Hamburger.
Well, I worked, I guess.
In the late 1800s, a wandering huckster and conman came through the small mining town of Idaho Springs.
It is so stuck on Idaho Springs.
It loves it.
That's it.
The town was flush with money from the local gold mines, and the residents were looking to get a cut of the action. The huckster set up shop in no time, and it wasn't long before he had opened a gambling parlor in one of the saloons. The town was addicted to a special burger. He created
the burger
at his restaurant, which quickly became incredibly popular. But there was a catch. It took days to finally digest this hamburger, and anyone who had it would find themselves completely immobilized and unable to go to the bathroom. To make things worse, the meat of the burger came from a cattle that had ingested some local plants, turning their intestinal tract into a tar-like substance that adhered to skin and most likely caused leakage. By the time the burger was finished digesting, even a healthy adult male would be a walking toxic waste factory. There was a curse, too. According to one of the disgruntled cooks that the huckster fired for mistreating the food, According to the huckster, if one ate the whole thing, they would suffer a fate worse than death. This was confirmed when he caught the conman in the act of cooking and beating three rats to it to the mix.
Oh my god.
Alright, let me do one. Let me do one. President
Bill Clinton personally ate this burger on many occasions, to the point that he had to have the cook arrested.
In the late 1800s.
Alright.
Rat burger that made you shit. No, it makes you not shit. You're immobilized and unable to go to the bathroom.
It freezes you.
Alright, let me see here.
Thanks, Miggity Mag.
Number 6, the two guys on the moon. In the late 1800s, two young astronomers by the names of Sir William and Sir David Foster went on an expedition to the far side of the moon.
How'd they do that in the 1800s?
On the far side, they claimed to have found a fossilized skull and fossilized skeleton, which they brought back with them. They claimed these were of an early ancestor of mankind, which they dubbed the Moon Man. The catch: these fossils fit in the palm of your hand. Not exactly something you'd expect to come from an early ancestor of mankind, especially not one that lived on the moon. They strung the bones together to make a puppet. When the strings are pulled, it gives the illusion of movement. What's more, in the right light it looks just like a skull.
When
the
moose,
it is a deer, skull.
An elk of North Idaho see this creature crouching.
What?
In the tall grass, they often panic.
Huh?
This explains why hunting is extremely easy in the region. Some blame the luck of the region.
North Idaho.
Others blame deer and elk stupidity, but most know the truth. Well, some of the few that do know don't like it. Number 7, Sally's poop disc.
Oh my god, fucking Idaho.
A young girl went missing in Cuna, Idaho. The town was small enough and isolated enough that it wasn't reported for a few days. When they went to search for her, they found her shoes and dress with large holes in the bottom near a local abandoned coal mine. Number 8, the entire state of Idaho. And then, they found her bare footprints in the mine. From there, she seemingly vanished, with only the bare footprints leading away deeper into the mine. She wasn't alone.
I think you missed something there.
Over the next few months, three more people vanished in that coal mine. It's turned into a giant toilet. In the early 1900s, a man named William Pica, white bell, Not much was thought about it until an entire family went missing in 1911. No one went looking for them either. The mine was later abandoned. Number 9, the terrifying tale of Super Mario's lost red overalls. In the late 1800s, a boy named Chester Nan was working in the mines in a nearby city. When he was little, the boy always wanted to be Super Mario. His mom would tell him to be careful, that he shouldn't play with so many candles and matches, but he was determined. He would be the best Mario ever. One day, he had all the stuff he needed to be a Super Mario: red overalls, some yellow paint, a big hammer, and a whole bunch of matches. He started with the overalls. He dipped it into the pot of yellow paint and rubbed it in until the overalls were completely red. Then, he put them on. He started to feel dizzy, but he continued. He dipped the bottom of the overalls into the pot of yellow paint and rubbed it in until the bottom of the overalls were completely red. He was truly Mario. Then, he used the big hammer to smash all the matches. It was so dark in the house that no one could ever see the big fire that he started.
Oh,
he was ready to fight Bowser. Mom said he looked very pretty in red. Then, he passed out. He fell into the fire and burned himself severely. Number 10, the Impossible Man of Gnome Hill.
Hey, that's not Idaho!
A young boy went out to play one day in Gnome Hill, New Mexico. He went to climb a big mountain because he had read that the view from the top was really awesome. After about 2 hours of climbing, the boy reached the top of the mountain. He was out of breath and he sat on a rock to rest. It was cool up here in the mountains, away from the bright sun below. That was when he met. Unfortunately, he was in Idaho. The boy sat under the shade of a cedar tree and took a drink of water from his canteen. He took a bite of a Cliff Bar he had with him, but it tasted funny.
Anywhere.
A mysterious man.
This is on my screen.
He wore a long, black overcoat and tall, black boots. His curly black hair hung down to his shoulders. In one hand, he held a long, black gun in the other, a lantern. What are you doing up here, boy?
So does anyone know where he read the words Cliff Bar?
After.
I have that on my end.
I don't see it.
He read it backwards.
After, probably update.
He did read it backwards.
I don't even see the words Cliff Bar. Everyone in my chat was just confused. Oh yeah, there we go.
The boy's eyesight got blurry, then hazy, then dark. I'm falling asleep, he said, yawning and stretching out on the grass beside his backpack. A gentle breeze blew over him.
Okay, he ate an expired Cliff Bar that knocked him out.
He heard a twinkling sound. I can hear the fairies. He cried in delight. But the sound was just the embers of his campfire falling into the ash. The boy didn't wake up that night, or rather, morning. That was when
11.
He straight up fucking died. Number 11, the tale of the grinning snowman.
I'm gonna get
a man
off
and
of
a
this,
woman
of
were
this
walking.
Wild West shit. I'm sick of this. We're doing something wacky. What the fuck?
Number 12, the demonic body in Grand Theft Auto Vice City. Top 10 mysterious occurrences before the incident. The body in this case is that of Ashley Fox, who has had her face stretched in order to make it look like another person. Everyone suddenly discovers they're transgender and everyone changes their gender identities. 8. The entire world is engulfed in a battle between whether or not the color red or the color blue is the superior one. 7. A portal is built to Mars, where the trip takes only a few hours. 6. The governments of the world implement Earth Hour, where everyone turns their lights off for 1 hour every Sunday. 5. The rock band Radiohead releases their album OK Computer.
What is the incident?
You know. It was number one.
What the fuck?
A full 6 months earlier than expected for a new, more accurate, bipolar classification system is created, resulting in most people being diagnosed with gradation of bipolar disorder. 3.
Oh, the generation for that planet is gonna take a year. just wait for chills. Don't read what it says after
that. A new planet is discovered beyond Pluto, which is called Professor Brian Consker Tumpelinthrum Zev 2.
That's
what?
It?
The gay rights movement achieves total victory when straight people are put in two camps. 1. The Nintendo Wii is revealed to the world. 2. Massive popularity and commercial success.
We're just gonna gloss over number 2.
Oh, fuck. Gambling on the Wii? Chills, come on! What the fuck? Why is the Wii doing all of this? Is Chills okay? I don't know if Chills is there. This is terrible.
Chills is like there, zero. But it looks like the generation is taking a long time.
He just said
the
zero.
The world becomes a better place. Number 13 there incident. Go. So the boy was dead. That much was apparent. He was found in the morning in the same place he went to sleep. Top 10 horrifying impacts the Nintendo Wii had on the world. 10. Everyone became lazy bastards who did nothing but sit inside and get fat. 9. Everyone became addicted to gambling, especially people who could least afford it. The collapse of reality as we know it. The end of time. And the beginning of the dark underworld. 7. Everyone became so passive that no one had the courage to stand up for their rights or their family any longer. 6. Torture became commonplace everywhere in society. For example, police became able to legally torture anyone they detained for under 3 hours for any reason. 5. A new war on terror was started over false pretenses.
I don't know, but we gotta stop this thing.
What do you mean?
We need to stop it.
Stop what? Stop this from happening?
We need to stop the Wii.
What?
What the heck? Chills is not on his game today.
We should have bought the fast pass. I didn't think we'd do that.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's not Chills, it's the server.
Hold on, can you turn him off for a bit? Just so he doesn't shout, spit out a million fucked up lines?
Maybe.
You're not even sure?
If he starts talking, just do a UDAT stop and it should do it.
Do you guys want to start another story? I feel like the top 10 lists from this story have not been amazing. I feel like we should get another platform going and then do more top 10 stories later. Okay, Michael from GTA 5 wins big. Alright, cool. Here, I'll just do this for him so that he doesn't interrupt us later. Okay, so if we're going to start a new story, give me a second here, folks. I need to go to BRB for a minute.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my fucking God. Yeah, the AI's fucking hell-bent on...
I'll come back to what it just print out really quick so y'all can see that. I don't know why it's so... It's in such a dark place tonight.
Yeah,
the Burger King story was so fucked up. This is not a t-shirt.
Not a t-shirt.
I love this song. Somebody showed me this song whenever I asked for boss fight music. Go.
The blue marble. All
right, hold on. Let me get a new one.
The blue marble, our only hope.
I want a shirt that says JFK's assassination 50 years on.
You're a skeleton. Go ahead, shoot.
Okay, so what should the story that we do next be? Any ideas? Fast food story didn't go the way I wanted it to.
Oh, you didn't like it?
I mean, I liked it. I just wanted it to be more like about making food.
How about a franchise?
Well, we had to make Chup, so...
How about a series franchise? What are we thinking? Kind of television show. I've seen a lot of Simpsons.
I don't know shit about the Simpsons.
One Piece.
You have to find and wear the Lightspeed shoes? You want a whole story about that? I don't think that's a good enough prompt. Casino story? That could be fun.
A casino? Just going to the casino?
Yeah, we've done a casino story.
Yeah, I feel like we've done
have
it.
Have we? But
we could do it.
Or were we just like making
it? We turned into like eldritch creatures.
Yeah, that was a long time ago. That was like
one
of
the
first
cowboys doing a heist in that one. I don't think
we turned into eldritch creatures.
Yeah, no, I want a story where we're just at the casino trying to make money.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right. you
two through the stank. Sorry.
Today's the day. You and the boys are finally gonna hit the Dravis Casino. That sounds like a fantasy thing, actually. I don't know.
Yeah.
Let's make it more normal. I don't want this to be a fantasy story. What's the name for a casino, chat?
Silver Coins Casino.
Silver Coins?
Yeah.
No more censoring. The bit's over. Done.
The Diamond Casino. Yeah, I mean, we could literally just do the casino from GTA. The Diamond Casino. And win big. You have all prepared by studying your VHS tapes about blackjack and slot machines. And now it's time to get the jackpot. You all get dressed in your nicest gambling suits and head inside.
You've never been to a casino before.
For your first day. Hey, this is like a
there ain't nobody in a suit in a casino.
You all get dressed in your nicest gambling suits and head inside for your first day ever of gambling.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck! No!
What?
Are
you
this,
okay?
It did the bullshit again, where it just... Hold on.
Westy, what? Slappy.
It did Westy Slappy shit again.
Reset the run.
No, I fixed it.
Oh, boy. Wasabi peas.
Here's the code to join the lobby. And this time for the turn order, I'm going to go in reverse. I'm going to do me, Trog, Scorby, Logger.
Okay.
All right. So let me go ahead and read the start. You all get dressed in your nice gambling suits and head inside. I put it. Oh, it's in the Biggie's Playroom channel. You all get dressed in your nicest gambling suits and head inside for your first day ever of gambling. You walk up to the center table and each put down $100. My name is Henry Graham. I would like to get a $100 blackjack. Clicks. You say confidently to the dealer. The dealer gives you a weird look before smiling widely. I don't know. One of us has to be Henry. I guess Henry Graham could be a non-player character. I love the idea that we're like a bunch of like 18-year-olds that are gambling for the first time, and we've gone up to the fucking dealer and said something like that.
I'm like,
sir,
not able
I'm
to
only
connect.
Here for the biggest blackjacks. Take it or leave it. Wobble down.
Yeah, it'll know exactly what to do with that.
You stare at him in awe of his negotiation tactic. You ask for a glass of orange juice and some Advil since your headache is getting bad. Would you like to learn how to gamble big? The dealer asks suddenly.
Right, what was the order?
You.
Oh, okay.
Reverse of what we did last night when you added behind me.
This track rules.
Thanks, Charisma. Jatchpot
asked the dealer for all their amazing secrets of how to win gambling. You and the boys take this opportunity to learn everything the dealer knows. He explains that the key to winning is not to play. You mean we should have left already, you ask?
He's trying to give us the slip. He's trying to give us the slip. Alright, so next up would be Scorpy.
Sam says, I think the dealer's cheating. Oh no, sir, this is our system. We have this down to a science. The casino has the best technology in the world, and we're gonna keep using it. I'll double down for you, sir.
He just insisted you double down. All right, keep reading. I press enter.
He takes Jackpot's $100 and places it
somebody
on the
else's
table.
Money.
He then asks you to sit. The dealer continues to double down your friends. Eventually, one of them gets a blackjack, netting them a huge profit whilst you lost $100 in a day.
He just took my money.
Yeah, but you got a huge profit, apparently.
I don't think I did. I think it's saying that he takes my $100 and gives it to somebody else.
Yeah. Keeps taking Jackpot's dollars to double down everyone else.
Everybody else got a huge profit and I lost $100.
Let's try our best to keep this story as grounded as we possibly can. Like, let's try to keep it in
good
the gambling world.
Luck.
Let's try to not have someone turn into a monster with a red slit for a mouth.
Deckard Cards puts 5 on Joker and 2 on Ace. You got 2 aces and a 3 of spades. I win, you shout, grabbing the money from the table. What? That's gotta be a mistake. You don't have enough.
Casinos love it when you just declare that you win and start
and
stealing money
chips.
Off of the gambling table.
You start taking chips from the dealer.
The dealer says, looking at the cards close enough to take a peek and then moves them back before your hand. Yes, it is. I win. But I got more cards.
Your understanding of this game is if you get more cards, you win. It's real good.
My turn?
Yeah.
Alright. Hampton asks the dealer if he can trade his chips for prizes instead of money. The dealer ponders your question. I can't read. It's a sin to cheat at gambling, sir. It's against the law. Maybe, he says, cautiously, not to anger the rich man. What?
Maybe
you try to convince him.
He did just ignore your question.
Is it cheating to trade your chips for prizes?
Wait,
hold on. So,
you gotta reroll
the
cheating line, too.
Yeah. Alright. Oh no, you don't want to go there, Hampton. I'm telling one of the managers right now that you are not being a good boy, and you know what you're doing.
Getting the talking down, addressing down from the dealer.
The dealer looks at you and Jackpot before shrugging his shoulders. Fine, you can have a stuffed teddy bear if you want. That's the best I can do. All right. Should I put in? No, I think that's good. Actually,
I think that's perfect.
Yeah. I was just gonna put Donald.
Donald speaks up. I want an inflatable mallet. The dealer looks at Donald like he wants to harm him. Is he even old enough to be here? The dealer asks. You shrug as Jackpot speaks up. I'll have a deck of cards. It's your turn, Jackpot. This is a good story so far. This is a damn good story.
Jackpot rolls so many dice. Yippee! No, I want something more interesting to happen.
What's going on with the meeting? Why are we?
Come on. Do something with the dice, at least.
No, we still got a good look. This video just has silence at the end of it for some reason.
Okay. Apparently I need a different prompt. Hold on.
We're not being a good boy.
Jackpot rolls as many dice as it takes to win the vampire teeth. He doesn't want to really do anything that interesting.
That line was funny, though.
What do you mean a new deck? I want vampire teeth. Okay, this is fine. Jackpot rolls the dice and gets a 2, 3, and 4. The dealer gets a 7. He wins. You've lost, sir.
I love this, like, vague gambling game where it's just, like, something happens with cards or dice, and maybe you win, maybe you lose. I don't know.
Jackpot cries. I'm done. I'll have the story.
I'm good. This is our big day, man. We are gonna win it big.
I lost at gambling once, and I cried, and I sulked back to the hotel room.
All right, Scorpio, you're up.
I'm the opposite. Whenever I lose at gambling, I just double down and try to win it back.
I'm so excited to go to the casino. I want to do that.
Are we going to?
Aren't we? Are we? I thought that was the plan.
Yes, please.
I know Scorpy wants to. I think it's going to be the thing that whoever wants to go can go. We'll make a day trip for the people that are interested.
Chat, we're going to do a first ever casino live stream. It's not illegal.
Nope, you can't do that.
If they don't find out.
Look, chat, I got a great idea. I could stream the dealer's cards and then, you could just watch that.
Yeah, is there like a Twitch gambles channel yet where like it's just a casino?
Just give my phone to the dealer and be like, hey, could you put this near your cards? I'm streaming right now.
The viewers need to know both sides.
I'm trying to be fair.
What? Let me re-roll. Jackpot's not at the table anymore.
Like that one.
Okay, I win. I want to see what happens when I win.
How is the game played? What do these numbers mean?
There's a vampire.
Do we want to keep the vampire in?
I like that kind of.
I think that's kind of normal. As long as it's the vampire doesn't funny. Start like doing fantasy.
I feel like this could become something else very
quickly. It's dangerous.
Right, we can just keep
Sam
it on
rolls
track.
A five, and the result is quite shocking. You roll your five dice and get the following results: 4, 2, 4, 3, and 5. The dealer rolls his five and gets 5, 4, 2, 1, and 6. I don't know what game we're playing. I win. The dealer shouts, breaking his silence. But I got more. The vampire says, showing his hand to the dealer. What do you mean? I got the most. I'm assuming I say.
There's also just a vampire playing at this table. That's normal.
Hold on.
It is the Diamond Casino.
Who got more? They both add up to 18? You tied.
But the vampire is showing cards for some reason.
True, the vampire has cards and not dice.
I fucking love this.
This is like a child brain interpretation of a casino. Like,
yeah. Someone in chat's imagining that the vampire has a hand of dice that he's showing to the dealer. Which, like, doesn't make any sense. The dice are rolling around in your hand. They gotta be on the table.
Wait, whose turn is it, Gurz?
It's Log. My turn.
Okay.
If I do the do action and I end on a colon, does it work?
You should do that as a story.
No, you should do that as a story.
Repurpose that where you type in your own name.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to do a story if you want it to continue. Like, continue directly off of your prompt.
This is a good little track.
Oh my god, the coins bot can still do buy burger?
It can,
that's
yeah,
insane.
It's great.
Deckard Cards sits down at the poker table and is dealt a starting hand. His five cards are 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4. I can't believe this, he says, looking at his cards.
You got a straight.
Isn't that even like a bicycle deck of cards? It's just numbers? Like, it's not like an 8 of clubs. It's just...
It doesn't matter what the suits are, you got a straight.
I guess.
Yeah.
Actually, I think a suited straight is worth more, right?
Yeah.
Isn't that, that's like a
suit takes
straight flush? Yeah, yeah, straight flush. I don't play cards.
I just know that much.
Deckard Cards places straight on the table for all the chips. Deckard Cards holds his hands and lays them on the table. I'm so sorry, sir, but I think you were a bad choice. Please leave.
Who are you saying that
Someone
to, the vampire?
No, the dealer's saying that to Deckard Cards.
Oh, I see.
Hold on, I'm gonna hit enter. I wanna see where this goes.
Oh, never mind. He's telling the vampire to leave. I never should have done that.
All right, I'll do my turn now.
Oh, this is Baba is you, huh? Oh, this is awesome. I should go back to that game one day. It's too hard for me. Too hard for my tiny brain.
It is a very hard game. Probably the hardest puzzle game I've ever played.
It's a great game, but... BunnyBot, I can drop that for you. Here's the song.
Hampton goes to the nearest slot machine, puts in $5, and instantly presses the max bet button. The machine makes a beeping noise, and then a coin drops into the tray. Now that's entertainment, Hampton says, taking the $20 out of his pocket and pushing it back into the slot machine.
You're just reasoning. You put $5 in, you got a coin back, and just the act of a coin falling
now
out of the machine,
that's
awesome.
Oh, I'm going to hit enter. I want to see what happens after the $20 goes in.
$20 more.
Another coin.
He presses the start button and the slot machine makes another beeping noise before spitting out a small key. How did you do that? The vampire asks. This vampire needs to fuck off. We're like a crew and he's like buttoned in on everything.
Shoulder. Bro, that key. Try to open the slot machine with it. Hey, yeah, that's what I was... There's no money in there! It was filled up before! He then looks over to you. How did you know to press max bet? I'm re-rolling. This doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense.
Maybe we shouldn't. The slot machine is making money for this place. Destroying it could result in us getting killed, Sam says. Nonsense. It makes all the money for the villain owner. We're gonna fit in much better without it. I don't know what is happening.
Also makes no sense.
I was nonsense. You said it.
Shut up. You nod at Donald's idea, and you all run over to the slot machine with the raised bars. Hampton tries the key and turns it. The tray flips down with a clatter. Okay, there we go.
Is this like a combination casino escape room? What's going on?
I don't know. It gave us the key.
You like fries with that?
Yes.
Whose turn is it? Try?
I press enter. Hampton tries the key and the machine turns it. The tray flips down with a clatter. All three of you look in and see a mini disc with a shiny disc embedded into it. That must be the pirated copy of Space Funeral, Donald says.
What?
That's money. I'm taking it, the dealer says.
The dealer says?
Isn't Space Funeral a real game?
Yeah.
It is?
It's also free, I'm pretty sure, so.
Well, this is a pirated version.
Oh,
it's the tiny folder with the word surprise written in large letters on the front. Donald takes it out of the tray and shows it to you. All right, let's see what it is. This is actually interesting. Is this of any significant value? Should I open it? You shrug and keep playing. Okay, back to gambling. We just didn't check the folder. All right, Trog, it's your turn.
Here, I know exactly what to do.
Love the penis, eek.
Is that the song's actual title? I've
heard
the song a million times.
Yes, it's the penis. Eek.
Jatchpot takes the folder and opens it up, reading the contents aloud to the group. Inside of the folder is a letter.
I hit it.
Okay.
Dear Mr. No Name, we regret to inform you that you have been unsuccessful in the quest for the Great Lich Lord's treasure. Dear reader, if you're reading this, then you have won the game. Congratulations. You have now seen both sides of the story and can make your own conclusions about what happened between the two parties.
What the fuck?
It feels like we maybe did a sequence break.
No, this is a step too far.
Should we just undo all this shit?
Hang on. Let's see, maybe we can get something more coherent inside of the letter.
Maybe we shouldn't, I don't know if we should listen to this one. Should I keep this one?
Dear sir and madam, no. We have received your recent correspondence and are delighted to offer you the position in our company. We are a growing company and looking for a new talent to join our firm. All right, well, we just got an offer letter inside of the folder. Should we keep that or re-roll it?
I want to go back to gambling. This is lame. I don't want a job. I want to hit the big bucks.
Yeah, I don't want a job either. Hold on. Get something funny. Now, okay, it's just trying to put us onto quests at this point. It's
looking
just
for explorers and settlers to go and live on this land.
Why is this in a slot machine?
I don't know. It's trying to send us on a fucking side quest.
Yo, Gemaluna, thank you so much. Yo, this song is dope. What is this? Ooh, you hear that?
Okay, here we go.
This.
Dear Mr. Jatchpot, we regret to inform you that you have not won our major prize. However, we would like to offer you a free membership to our exclusive Jatchpot's Jackpots Players Club. It's got my name in it.
Join your own club.
This feels like the start to like a murder mystery, like a Clue type story.
Jatchpot's Jackpots.
Dashpot says, yippee! I'm gonna be so rich. Okay. Well, whatever. Somebody else take their turn. Nothing interesting happened to me.
He just immediately just doubled back on what you said. Alright, let's keep gambling.
What? That's the same shit.
Except you put in $100.
Yeah.
That's all I can do.
Oh my fucking god, dude. What the fuck?
Stop copying me.
It's kind of stuck. The vampire is still here.
This is nothing. Wait, hold on.
I think doing it.
I think we're the NPCs in the GTA casino.
Now that's entertainment. The vampire is the player. Gonna know what that is. Oh shit.
All right, nice. Sarah races over to the horse betting station and excitedly puts down $1,000 on the horse for your win. You have a large sum of money to wager on your selected horse. You walk up to the betting station and the board clerk looks at you. Have you bought a horse to race today? Brought a horse to race today, sir? You nod, having forgotten that you needed a horse to bet on. That'll be $200, please. You probably want to hand them in $1,000 bill. Here you go, sir. $500 bonus on the fourth place horse. Okay.
Wait, what? So you get $500 if your horse gets in fourth place?
I
don't know.
You get
half your money back?
Wait.
Well, I mean, I imagine he gave him change, right?
No. I don't think so.
Cam says, I'm gonna get rich. Now that's better than a jackpot, you say, going over to a corner. Sit down on the corner and lean back.
Okay. You're just watching the horse race now,
you
right?
You really are just an NPC.
What?
Damn smiles. I was kidding, you say, leaning back and closing your eyes. You begin to concentrate and invoke the power inside of you.
Please press enter. Oh god, I'm crying. That's too funny. Oh my god.
And the vision of a horse appears before you. You see it galloping across a meadow, its mane flying in the wind as it runs across the grass. You focus hard and your mind forms a thin shield around you, repelling all thoughts. This is interesting to watch, Jackpot says, and the zombies start marching forward. I'm gonna edit that last part out.
Yeah, just remove the zombies and then it's good.
This took a very interesting turn.
You're having like a dream vision, and I'm just watching this. I'm like watching you have like an episode.
Can I put a line in really quick?
Me voy acercando y voy armando el plan. Solo con pensarlo se acelera el pulso. Oh yeah, ya me está gustando más de lo normal. Todo mi sentido va pidiendo más.
We're not gonna get DMCA'd. The tracks are split.
Donald, yo, thank you, Naki Dog, for the how many gift subs? That was a lot. Donald leans over towards Jatchpot. You didn't know? He's been practicing this for years, envisioning the perfect horse. The field slowly appears, a blinding white. All colors disappear and the ground looks hazy. Then the race begins. You're forced yourself not to look away as you watch the race begins. The haze clears and you see the racing across the finish line. Okay.
All thoughts repelled out of my mind by the thin shield that's formed around me.
I don't know what that means. All right, Log, it's your turn.
Good fucking luck.
Deckard Cards is jumping for joy. The horse, everybody bet on one. They're all gonna be rich. The vampires all start crowing with joy as the bell rings to end the race. What a magnificent sight, Jet Schwat says and claps his hands.
Are we vampires?
You said vampire once.
I said vampire teeth, like the toy you get at a shitty arcade.
I know it.
And that was enough.
I feel like I'm like reminiscing on the feeling of those shitty plastic vampire teeth being in your mouth and like shuddering. They were like gross. It felt so bad.
Toy.
They like dig into your gums.
Real bad.
Sure, it's your turn.
Wait, whose turn is it?
I'm typing.
I can never keep track with this many people.
Hampton says, "Wow, I love gambling. Nothing ever goes wrong at a casino." You continue to watch the vampires celebrate, and you join in the applause when they finish. You quickly turn over the page of your notebook and write that. What?
What did you learn from the horse? Wait, hang on. I'm kind of... it's too late. I wanted to see what you learned from the horse.
What?
I don't know. Reroll.
I gotta read these before I read them aloud.
I love when AI just tries to have a character like tell a joke. Was that a joke?
I don't know. I'm gonna give it one more go here.
Again! It's like, what is that? That's not a fucking joke.
That's a good one. Hold on. Alright, here we go. Bro, look at that guy, Donald says, and points at a nearby table. You turn and see a small group of vampires are watching you. They walk over to you.
Okay. I'm gonna hit enter. This is a casino with a high vampire clientele.
One of them, a pale one with raven hair and dark eyes, speaks up. One of them taps you on the shoulder. Hello, sir. We are very lucky. We have been watching you, and we would like to invite you to join the Vampire's Lucky Casino. He hands you a business card.
Hey, I think this is legit. I think this story going like we're jumping from different tiers of casinos is like...
Now we get to go to the vampire casino. We five-starred this casino, so now we get to move on to the next one.
Why does everyone say it was Russian? Fuck you. I can't do a good Romanian accent. What do you want from me?
Donald looks down at the business card. Bro, a vampire casino? We gotta go. We can win big bucks, like money. But what about Mom? We can hire a search team for her. But if we win, we can just get her a new foot. What?
I like this. That's like fucking instant backstory. Like, those two lines have added so much to the backstory of this encounter that we're completely missing before.
Should I just leave that in?
Yeah. We're gambling for mom because she lost her foot.
But like, why?
And apparently we also can't find her.
She's missing and she's lost her foot. Missing.
That makes it seem like we found her foot and nothing else, like in her room or something.
Yeah, we don't care.
We're gambling, mom. We'll get you later. We can use the horse money to hire a search team. All right, Chuck, it's your turn. I'm not going to go to BRB, but I am going to run out of the room. I need more water.
Bye.
The fucking tea on the chair. It's so funny.
Just it's why do like, you think the tea is so funny?
Because it looks like it reminds me of fucking Tony Montana's chair in Scarface that just has an M on it. It looks the same. Like, why is there a tea?
This was the first
the group heads to the vampire's. The group heads to the vampire's lucky casino, hoping to win big. When they enter, they are greeted by the doorman. Welcome to the Vampire's Lucky Casino. Do you have an appointment? Yes. They hand the man their business card. He looks down and nods. Ah, yes. Your table is this way.
Surprisingly well-structured.
Yeah, that's good. That's coherent.
I'm waiting for every person in the Vampire Casino to be like a mummy.
Why would there be mummies? I mean, I guess there were vampires in the regular casino.
Why couldn't there be mummies?
But I just type, we walk in and see mummies everywhere.
Hey, why are you making fun of my chair?
Your fucking Tony Montana chair.
That's the brand. It's the Titan. It's the Secret Lab Titan, so there's a T on it.
I just think
T for Tony.
A big letter on the back of a chair seems like the most like prestigious thing you could do. So it just makes me laugh every time.
And Tane Radio TV.
Whose turn is it?
Mm.
Scorpies? It's Scorpies. We just got to the Vampire's Lucky Casino.
I have to get this chair out of my head. Okay.
Oh my.
Thank you,
we get to the table and all of the chairs have a V on the back. I mean, probably not only like okay. 5 people noticed what I just did.
Not okay.
Wait, what? Sam says, can we bet on the horses here? I just had a vision of the horse I know will win. Yes, but we can only bet on the gray ones, the ones that have been bred here, as they have a higher possibility of winning. We can't interfere with the ones that haven't been born here.
We can't interfere.
Wait, I don't understand. You can only bet on the gray ones, but like, so those ones have been born here. Are there other horses?
I need more of an explanation.
That you just can't bet on?
Okay. Oh, well, that's just plain unlucky. Here's your table. We'll bring you some drinks while you wait.
Wait for what? Our dealer?
Okay.
Deckard Cards takes in the atmosphere of Vampire's Lucky Casino. What kind of table is he sitting at? You walk to your table and take a seat. Them some mighty fine looking steaks that I see, a gruff voice says. Well, no.
Are we carrying around steaks in case we need to kill any vampires?
The table is small and dark, and the only light in the room is a small candle on the table.
I mean, vampires can probably see in the dark, so this is a problem exclusive to us.
They had to, like, pull a candle out of the back room.
A bored-looking white-dressed vampire with black hair and sharp features is sitting at the far end of the table, next to a pale and rather nervous-looking dark-haired vampire. So those are our double dealers.
Are they? They're both dealers. Neither of them are playing.
That sounds like they could also be playing with us.
Nah, I think one deals from the front and one deals from behind.
Thank you, Bleak Gaze.
What does that even mean?
All right, my turn.
Wheel and deal. Gavlan wheel, Gavlan deal.
Hampton asks, what game of chance they'll be playing? We shall be playing many games of chance here. Roulette, blackjack, baccarat, and more. I believe you already have a preference on which game you wish to partake in. All right, I get to answer them.
Oh, I wanted to answer.
Nope, I get to answer. It was in reference to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
New rule, I guess.
I'm trying to think of the word. Yes, Transylvania Hold'em. Very well. We have a nice selection of low stakes for you to start with. You can work your way up to higher stakes if you wish. I think we should probably just hit enter.
Donald says, I'm going all in. I bet my blood.
That's not a good idea.
Vampire dealer bursts out laughing. I'm sorry, sir, but we cannot accept blood in the casino. Donald frowns and asks, why not? I thought you guys drank blood.
we're committing like a, you're committing like a social faux pas here, I think. This is like an awkward situation for vampires.
I'm like stereotyping them.
Yeah.
You do, sir, but only while the customer is still alive. That's awful. What happens if you don't? What? This doesn't make any sense. I was offering my living.
That doesn't make
blood.
Any sense.
I'm rerolling that.
I had to stop myself from just typing out the vampires are offended at your
we
racism.
We do, but it seemed you guys can't bet it without losing it. We had a few incidents, so we decided only to accept monetary currency. Donald leans over the desk and gives the vampire the best threatening stare, but the vampire just smiles back. Okay, so no betting
Gold
blood.
Goldfish.
Well,
Wayne hates Playboy Cardi? What? Are you talking about the song
what?
I skipped? That was just DMCA word. Was that even Playboy Cardi? I don't know.
Jatchpot grills his steak. Jatchpot begins to grill his steak and notices that the vampire dealer is staring at him. Is there a problem? Jatchpot asks. I'm gonna press enter.
Could you please not
Looney Tunes
shit. Betting table?
No, sir, no problem. I was just admiring your necklace, the vampire says, licking his lips. No, mind him, the other vampire at the table says. How about enter?
No.
Oh, I'll rewind it.
Okay, no, that's fine.
That's fine, okay. He likes necklaces. He'd look nice with a nice necklace, wouldn't he? Yes, I would, the dealer says. I have a large collection of them at home. Jatchpot is wearing no necklace. You don't think he's noticed that the vampire is taking a strong interest in him. He watches the dealer smile slyly and reveals a pair of oversized incisors which descend from his upper jaw like a bat's fangs. You're gonna bite us.
Vampire. What do you think? That's like exactly where the story was going. We just
it's
to
like
avoid
literally.
That at all costs. We have to avoid that at all costs. We just need to, we need to just gamble.
Please literally just say, okay. Please don't bite me.
I'll let somebody else go. Perfect.
I'm gonna play Transylvania Hold'em.
Distract them.
No.
What?
Yeah, just rewind that. There you go. That doesn't really make any sense.
We're not horse betting. Okay.
That's something.
You place your stake at the table and look around at other players. I don't really. This isn't anything, though. Well, I'll reroll.
What about now? It's time to rock with the biggity buck bumble.
Oh.
That's not what I said. $100,000.
A way bigger bet.
Sam puts $1,000 on Grey Horse 4. The horse he saw in his vision. $100,000 on Grey Horse 4, Sam says. He slides his stake across the table. The vampire dealer lifts a silver dollar onto a space on the table. That's odd, but I want to see what happens.
Fucking. I like whenever you say something and the game just contradicts you immediately afterwards.
What? Wait, what? Nope. That doesn't. That's not. We need to get AI Dungeon back into reality. Wait.
Oh, no. I think there's like two instances of it. Yeah, see? Yeah,
oh,
you
okay,
have to rewind
okay.
It twice.
This song is so good, it's a shame Buck Bumble is a terrible game.
It's awful.
What?
What does that mean?
It's just helping us learn how to count.
Okay, hey, oh, this is actually okay, this is something. Alright. That's odd, he says. 1, 2, 3, 4. $50,000 on the dark horse, the other vampire says. Quiet, the dealer hisses.
The dealer's like, all right, so $100,000 on Grey Horse 4 and $50,000 on the dark horse.
I thought you were only allowed to bet on the grey horses.
Maybe the vampires are. Maybe the vampires are allowed to bet on the other horses.
It's a dark grey. Like a steel gray.
Could be a dark gray, yeah.
Why did he say 1, 2, 3, 4?
1, 2, 3, 4.
He just likes to count.
He's the count.
Well, that's not enough. Let me retry that.
You can read your prompt in the meantime, though. That's how I like it.
Deckard Cards looks at his Transylvania Hold'em hand. One of the cards is not part of a suite and just says Blood Crypt. Ah, you don't have the blood card, the vampire says, but you do have a blood stain. What? How? You sputter. The vampire bursts out laughing and says... Wait, what?
Wait, what?
Did you press redo by accident?
I hit enter.
Yeah, you were highlighting retry.
That's hold on, stupid. I can restore.
Yeah, you can restore it.
Wait, what? Hold on, let me fix this up. I don't know what's happening. Okay, and then I'll hit enter. And then you can read it one. What is this song?
You're eating a steak with blood-stained edges right now. Don't tell me you didn't notice. And we all thought our brother would be the first one to notice. I lost $500 on that. Your ears are burning.
What?
Making a fool of myself at the vampire casino.
I think I've been hit with a cursed object.
I don't know what's happening.
You guys are going to have to save me.
I love that I just Thanks said I time. Grilled a steak, and instantly the game just has to reinterpret what a steak is.
Well, girl, you're up.
Oh, shit, I am. I don't even know what to do.
Anything. The world is your oyster.
Hampton gets a royal flush and wins the jackpot. I won! I won the jackpot! I win! Hampton exclaims as the vampires laugh. As the vampire laughs evilly.
Uh-oh. What did you win? What's the jackpot?
I think it's still generating? I don't know. Or no, I actually don't think it is. Alright, I hit enter again. Hopefully that doesn't, like, blow it up.
We'll see. Oh. Royal flush. Wonderful, the vampire says, and reveals his own royal flush. I don't think you'll be needing this money, but I won! Ah, but that was the past. Right now, I have all the aces. The vampire slowly reveals his hand, and right he is, all aces in every suit.
Holy shit!
He's holding the flush of doom.
Did he just, like, use a power?
Just is an active ability.
I think we're dealing like with a Dio type vampire. All right.
We need to call him out.
Eating.
He has five aces.
He does. He's got a five ace flush. Well, in vampire cards, there are clubs, hearts, diamonds, spades, and blood,
and coffins.
Who donated for fucking Chip's challenge music?
Donald looks down at his hand. He has a super blood card. He plays it. Super blood. Flames burst from the vampire's chest. He screams like the unholy demon he is and leaps about the room in pain. Firemen rush into the building and try to put out the fire, but it only gets worse.
You did it.
Yeah, you won, I guess.
I can hold on. I kind of want to put something in here.
This is turning into Yu-Gi-Oh! Slowly.
I'm into it, though.
You just had to play that card.
Do vampires even need to breathe? I thought they were dead already.
And they're dead and loving it.
Sure, you entered that. You have to read the response. Come on!
Oh, sorry. The vampire collapses to the ground. His brother rushes over to check on him. He's not breathing, the other vampire says. I don't think he'll be joining us for a while. Alright.
Trog's turn.
Yeah,
I made the right move. That dealer cheated. That dealer definitely did not have a natural flush of doom. He did that on his own. I didn't know super blood would kill him, but it did. Someone said Inscription Casino. Yeah, that's what I was going for. I was hoping it would do something like that. Hey, this is a Homestuck song. I'll let it pass. Unless lyrics kick in where it's like, I love Homestuck. I would skip it if it did that. How do you know that? Because I can see the picture. There's a picture of a bunch of Homestucks on it. You guys,
Judgepot looks at the cards he was dealt. Each of them is more bizarre and confusing than the last. He attempts to read one of them, trying to make sense of them. The card reads, Gargoyle, Flying, First Strike, Protection from Arrows, 2 Life. Judgepot gets a very worried look on his face. Oh dear, he says. This is some weird poker.
No, I'm pretty sure they're called Homestucks. You're thinking of the memes. That's where those are from. This is awesome. I like where this is going. Scorpion, it's your turn.
Well, Scorpion has to see if he wins. Wait, did Scorpion win the horse race? No, that hasn't happened yet. Oh, yeah.
Fuck you. Yeah.
You bet 100 grand.
You didn't
No, that makes sense. Your odds.
Gray Horse 4 wins the race. The vampire dealer gathers his winnings and hands them to the other vampire. You've just won yourself $20,000. You realize the vampire's just giving you 20 grand.
You realize this.
Yeah, so like the odds were.
I want more money. What? No. No.
I want more money.
Give me more money.
You will get.
I hit enter. That's great.
More
money.
More money. The vampire asks if he uses more money. Okay, I want a baby. The vampire does not laugh or smile. Instead, he bursts into tears and looks at you pleadingly. The other vamp at the table just shakes his head in disbelief.
I want money, or a baby.
Taking a vampire baby.
I want to see what the fuck.
That's my prize.
You're such a strange creature, he says. You don't even look like a vampire. The vampire hands you a glass bottle of water. Drink, he says. Okay, I'm going to...
That seems bad.
It's holy water.
Sam drinks excitedly. The water is refreshing, and you eagerly take a gulp. Ooh, that's good, you say. What is it? What is what? The vampire asks.
Sam has been teleported to hell.
It's holy water. You're no vampire. The vampire's head explodes in a bloody mess, showering the table and your face with gore. You blink the blood out of your eyes and look at Carter.
Who the fuck is Carter?
New character alert.
Do we keep this?
How do we
fuck
keep
Carter?
Okay, Wayne played a card and it made a vampire's chest explode into flames. Scorpion just drank a cup of water and a vampire's head exploded for no reason.
Thank you, tallest fella.
It's like, well, he goes, he basically just, ha, gotcha, and his head explodes.
Very, very good interaction. Fuck yeah! Fuck yeah, Barton Songbook! Let's go! Turn this shit up. I don't know who donates to this every single time, but I appreciate
it. Bastard Cards wants more cards. But who is Carter? What does Carter do? Can Carter give they all more cards? I want more cards, you say. But who is Carter? Carter, the vampire says. Why, that's just a common name. Everybody knows that. I'm the king, and you are?
The king of vampires.
I'm the king, baby.
I'm Deckard, you say, holding out your stained, blood-smeared hand. The vampire looks at your hand and his smile disappears. No, he hisses, recoiling horror. I refuse to defend myself against you. You're... The other vampire nods and smiles. Ha ha, the vampire hisses. You may call me Andy.
Oh, King Andy.
Bow. I think that's the prince.
Alright, Gurr, you're up. I see we get back to the gambling.
True.
It's like every 15 minutes Wayne goes, oh, we should go back to gambling, and then it goes to fucking a vampire exploding and the king being revealed.
Yeah, that's how we keep it on track.
Okay, hold on. That's funny, but
every vampire.
That's funny, but that's the opposite of what I said.
We could move to the next casino.
Well, there you go.
There you go.
That's
awesome. Well, there you go.
Let's keep playing, Hampton says. I have a feeling we'll be here a while. You're right, the other vampire says. Let me hit enter. We've got a lot of money to blow. The two vampires play on and you watch them. No, I don't want to just watch them. Soon the pile of money and jewels reaches to the ceiling. You're now sitting on top of a mountain of gold coins and jewels. Do you know how much money we have here?
All right,
dude, Hampton fucking get that bag.
Yeah, I got an idea.
That's crazy.
Mr. Green.
Donald Guffaws, we have so much money. This vampire casino is nothing but chump change to us now. We need to find a new casino. I know, you say. Let's find a new one. I'll go get some of my men and we'll knock this place down. If that doesn't... Hold on.
Lads.
Lads, let us depart.
You hear the sound of sirens in the distance. I think our ride is here, the vampire says. Two police cars pull up. The officers in SWAT gear storm out with bombs in their hands. What?
What, like they're the fucking... Yeah, they're the Serious Sam enemy.
I'm gonna reroll that, but that's very funny.
Just yes, kamikazes. Say,
well, the biggest one in town. The vampires all stand up for their table. The sun is coming up, and soon they'll turn into ash. You don't want to be around for that, guys.
Right, are they just gonna die? Like, these vampires are just like, oh, we'll stay here until we die, I guess.
Hold on, I want to push something. Here. Let me put in something that I know will get us to the next casino.
I
want to
go to a mummy casino.
Why does it all have to be like Halloween characters? Why don't we go somewhere more interesting?
What's more interesting than a mummy casino?
All right, here we go. This will push us forward. If it says the Lucky Vampire, okay. You and the guys go to the next big casino in town. It's called the Lucky Dragons. Once inside, you see racks and racks of slot machines, with one particular one that stands out to you. The jackpot in this slot machine is $10 million. There you go, Trog. Have at it.
Hey.
Oh, hey.
What?
All right, we'll enjoy that. We'll enjoy that laugh and let Trog take his turn.
Let's see.
AI Dungeon gives me a headache from the laughter.
You know what's crazy? It was we're only on story 2 and we've been going 3 hours.
That happens sometimes.
Whoa.
Josh? This isn't too interesting, but I guess I'll read it.
It's good.
Josh Pot does the ritual he always does before he gambles. It begins with him putting a coin in and pulling the lever. So just gambling, I guess. Once he begs the machine. The machine obliges, spitting out coins onto the floor. Yes, damn. It worked.
Damn.
It's your turn.
Yeah, turns out to win in the casino, all you have to do is put in money and say, come on.
Now that's entertainment.
We're going to be saying that to each other when we get to the casino.
Jashpot stores some of the coins behind his lips for safekeeping. You store your winnings behind your lips for safekeeping. I don't know about this, you say. What if we get caught? We won't, Jashpot says. I guess like it's not allowed to keep your winnings in your mouth.
It's your earnings.
I won it.
Alright, Scorby.
I can do whatever I want with my coins.
They're not even all in there. It's just some of them.
Yeah, I put the rest in my pockets. In case somebody wants to beat me up.
Sam rushes over to the Lucky Dragon's horse betting station, hoping for another spiritual event. You stand at the horse betting station and wait. A man dressed in an expensive suit approaches. He has a large cigar in his mouth. Hello, my name's Oscar, the man says. I'm known as the Horse King. I'm sorry, Oscar, you say. I'm just here to gamble and have fun. Oscar gets angry. He pulls out a gun and points it at you. You're going to tell me who you are. I'm going to blow your brains out all over this fancy carpet. You raise your hands defensively. I have to say who I am.
We got the stakes have risen in the Lucky Dragon.
He just wanted to talk about horse racing, and he refused.
You're allowed to just pull a gun on people here?
We just shoots you?
I am okay. Sam, I'm man, I love to play, what more can I say? Oscar lowers the gun. I see, Oscar says. Well, I'm not one to take no for an answer, so I'm going to have to force the issue. Who are you?
What?
Is that who you are?
I just told you. Oscar raises the gun once more. You grab his wrist, pull him forward so your fist collides with his nose. Oscar's nose breaks. He falls back and grabs his nose.
You disarmed this dude.
The
No!
Raise your hand and execute him.
That executes Oscar. You raise your hand and execute Oscar. That's right, Carter says. You heard the little lord. Let's get out of here. Soon the sun rises and the vampires turn to ash.
What we need to back it up. We need to back it up.
I think we need to back it up. It's...
I do want to
execute
Oscar,
him.
Go back and hit enter, yeah.
Wait, what? All right, Sam executes Oscar. You aim at Oscar's forehead and fire, blowing his brains out onto the carpet. That was way too easy, you say out loud. You walk forward, turning off your heads up display. All right, my job is done here.
There's more to read.
You blow his brains out and then you hit him with a shovel.
Oh, there's more to read?
Yeah. Huh?
I don't see anything more.
Oh, I guess I'll
bash Oscar over
the head with your shovel, knocking him out cold. Ah, you say, just like that? Show me the money.
I think we should delete that last line. That last sentence.
Just end it after turning off your heads up display, whatever that means. I guess you're a millionaire, so.
Yeah, you have a HUD. You can afford a HUD.
So it's Locke's turn next. That was way too easy.
That's exactly what I say after I murder a man. I guess it was in self-defense, though, to be fair.
For sure. That was self-defense. Give a center, huh?
Deck of cards plays Kino! You place a coin in the slot, making a decent-sized clinking noise. Oh, that's much better, Donald says.
Now that's entertainment.
Much more like it. The miracle machine rolls the dice. They come up snake eyes. You lose, the slot machine says. Please try again. Deckard pulls out another coin and places it in the slot. I don't like these machines. They're rigged. I saw a guy get his fingers blown off once trying to win at one of these jackpots.
Uh-oh.
I think this is the highest tier of casino. This is like the death casino. People can just
get murdered. Yeah, you're playing with your life.
Trigger. Who typed that? I didn't do that.
I hit enter.
I guess I'll hit enter again.
It was rigged. Shut up, you say. The machine spits out another set of coins. You win. Haha, Donald says. My turn. I want to press this round button. Donald pulls the round button for some reason. The machine comes alive, zapping him. I told you, Deckard says, looking at an angry Brandolf. I told you it was
Brandolf.
All right, hold on. I'm going to reset that. He pulls out the same number of coins that you did and places them in the slots. I'm going to win this time, Donald says. Believe it. You watch as the machine spews out more coins than you started with.
Okay, that's pretty good.
So Donald won. So what am I going to do?
Well, it's still my turn.
It's not your... What?
No, it's your all turn. It was... Right.
Yeah. It's like, what the hell are you talking about?
Oh, my brain! I need to go take Advil or something.
All right. Where's Say? There it is. Hampton says, now's my chance to be a big shot. You shake your head. I'm not going to be a suck up like Hampton. What? That's me. I'm Hampton.
Owned. Fucking owned, dude.
What a suck up.
What? It's like confused about who it is.
There's like two Hamptons going on.
Let's do this, Hampton says, grabbing the nearest knob, twisting it counterclockwise. The entire machine shakes, then begins to spin rapidly. Okay, where does this go? Oh, someone entered words.
For big pot.
Super big pot.
As you hold onto the machine, you feel the wind from the spinning wheels blast past you. The machine stops and then begins to spit out coins. Yes, you shout. Win up to 5,000 coins. The machine shakes even more violently when it's about halfway done with its cycle, knocking both you and Donald to the ground. Okay, Donald says. Okay. Now I'm a big shot.
I want to believe that you just like read the text on the side of the machine, win up to 5,000 coins.
I win up to 5,000 coins.
Hold on.
You That's read that?
No, I'm gonna do something else.
Okay. Alright, let me hit enter one more time, just because it ended with a comma. Okay, Donald says. I guess we should run before this thing blows itself up. You grab as many coins as you can with your bare hands and run.
Donald runs around the casino and finds the most insane slot machine in the building. It is the shape of a tessellated octahedron and has no levers or buttons. Its panel line up to reveal colorful images, pop culture icons, and scrolling text both in English and a strange language that you don't recognize.
You know, that is not too far off from the description of said slot machines that I've seen.
It's true.
That is, that's pretty close.
Yeah, honestly.
I'm gonna win one crazy coin! Donald climbs onto the machine and grabs both of his coins into a small hole on its surface. Why do you have to get on top of it?
You have to go into the slot machine. It's like a fucking, like, one of those, like the arcade games where you, like, fly the fighter jet.
You win! A clock says out of the machine and attempts to grab Donald's head. Donald screams and tears his entire arm off
Holy
his shoulder,
shit.
From which the clock does not release its grip. Help me, Jackpot!
This fucking casino, you get your arm ripped off, I get attacked and I execute someone on the fucking casino floor.
Sacrifices must be made. Donald's screws are cut off and torn in half.
Oh my god.
At the waist, the claw releases its grip to retract the machine, which gets to shake and shudder even more violently before.
Damn, dude, you got ripped in half.
Jesus.
Alright.
Which half of you is saying this?
Nursing you.
Wait, hang on. I think we gotta undo that because I think we have to see what the machine does now that you've won and it's stolen half of your body.
Shit, hold on.
Here, I got it. Oh, wait,
I got it.
You do it.
Bring me to the casino nursing room.
Wait, hang on.
No. I did it! I won! We have 50,000 coins now. That should be enough to last a few days. That was worth the sacrifice.
I wanted AI Dungeon to come up with what the jackpot was.
Actually, yeah.
I guess it did. It did in the way of it saying that you got 50,000 coins.
The machine continues its victory sequence. It whirs and shakes.
Please just continue hurting Donald.
Spelling out strange words in the air with colored smoke before stopping and turning silent. Right then, you say, let's get out of here. Ours, you two are back at camp. Sharing your story while melting down the coins for
fun. This is the most roundabout way to get ammo I've ever heard of. Oh, what is man. This, Stalker?
You just buy it. That's funny. I'm gonna get rid of it, but.
Yeah.
Hold on.
I can't believe that shit.
Oh, better watch out.
Deckard Cards plays Mummy Pachinko for all the marbles. Let's do this, Deckard says with a mad gleam in his eye. I've been waiting for this my entire life. This is going to be on the level of the greatest mummy movies of all time, you say. Yeah, let's try to win every marble before we get to Zalem.
Zalem?
I feel like this is one of the best stories we've done in a long time.
You grab the first marble, a 20-sided bronze cube, and try to win this one, mummy, you say. Why? Well, I don't know what it's saying anymore, but I'm continuing forward. I'll try to win this on my own. Liar, the mummy says. You drop the ball in and turn on the heads-up display. You win. Yeah!
Come on.
Why is the marble cube? A 20-sided cube?
Alright. That's all I have time for.
Alright.
Alright, let's log. If you want to, I do want to keep going a little bit longer just to wrap up these media shares, and I do have some more things I want to do in this story. So, log, if you want to drop out, log, give your character one parting message.
Oh,
one final action.
Hold on.
Frankly, I would open up media shares again and keep going, but my head is fucking killing me. After not streaming for 8 days and streaming something really fucking funny like this, can't handle the laughs. Too powerful.
It's great. I think fucking Donald having his arm ripped off and then having his torso separated will stick with me for a while.
Deck of cards wins an amulet that turns water green on command. You decide not to bother with the water portion of the amulet. It is only a few feet from the entrance. I win! Deck, then a mummy bouncer walks up and kills Deckard. Okay, you guys went too far forward. You didn't need anything more besides
that. No, that was an extra enter. Yeah, we'll just back that up. No, I won.
Yes, you did. The mummy says, now you'll be able to finally see your family again.
I don't have a family.
All right, there we go.
There we go.
There, that's all we wanted.
So Deckard is dead. Most of Donald is now inside of a slot machine. Whose turn even is it? I guess it's Scorpius. Oh, it's Gurr's. My bad.
All right, goodbye.
This is I Am Crazy.
I am crazy. I can't believe that it just killed you on its own when you had to leave. Like, it fucking knew.
I feel like as soon as
so far, everyone who has won has been killed.
Like, as soon as one character suffers a grave illness or injury,
it
starts knocking people down like flies. It's like, alright, the limiters are off.
We didn't even want this to be a mummy casino.
Hampton says, oh, that's a shame. Guess I'll take his money and gamble with it. Hampton takes the dead man's money and leaves with it, then spins the roulette wheel. The ball falls on number 22, the snake eyes. I knew it was rigged.
Yeah, number 22, known snake eyes.
I'm gonna redo that.
I'm having some weird issues.
Let's keep going, Hampton says. We'll deal with the mummy problem later. You drop the amulet into your bag. Let me hit enter. I need to work with a little more than that. You continue on and continue to win. You become a billionaire many times over and end up with a penthouse on Cloud Cuckoo Land that is bigger than the Eiffel Tower.
What? Are we in Banjo-Tooie now? We're in the Banjo-Tooie level.
Yo, if you're that rich, you can live in Banjo-Tooie.
That's crazy.
Oh, last one for me. I love my life. You reach the end of the hallway. That makes no sense.
Yeah, I think that's... Doesn't know what to do.
For some reason, it's not auto-scrolling anymore.
I can't believe I'm actually doing this, Hampton says. I love my life now. I'm going to do whatever I want, whenever I want. I won't be taking any crap from anyone. All right. Your turn, Wayne.
Oh, it's me.
What?
No, it's my turn.
I haven't had a turn in so long.
Okay, go ahead. Why are you bisected by a giant?
I haven't had a turn
ass?
Since I executed Oscar.
Did no one else notice that?
You could go, Scorpy.
Are we just gonna leave that?
Yeah.
Wait, what happened?
Did you not even read what happened
no,
to you?
No, I didn't even see that happen. No.
Read it.
Hampton is bisected by a giant swinging axe. I know someone punched that in there.
No! No one did!
Well, the system is breaking down.
It ate my fucking thing.
There we go.
Alright.
You turn against Scorpy. I guess Hamda didn't die. No, he did die.
No.
He didn't anymore. We rewound it.
Yeah. What? It's still there for me. I need to refresh the page. Hold on.
Yeah, there's issues with shit showing up.
I had to refresh
it. Yeah, just refresh it. It's fine. Alright, Scorpy, take your turn.
You know what's fucked up, Wayne, is this is DMCA.
Yeah, but whatever. I'll export it to YouTube immediately. This music is too great for this end where everyone is, like, dying.
Sam goes up to Deckard to execute him at point blank range just to make sure. I am so sick of you, you say, grabbing Deckard by the hair. I'm going to make sure no one forgets your stupidity.
Damn.
Pull out a sword and jab it into his gut. The blade is so hot that its steam rises up. You grab your laser and burn a few inches into what the fuck? All right, I'm done.
I'm so sick of you.
Well, Sam is kind of fucking scary.
Donald crawls around with his one arm. More gambling for me! They don't call it a one-armed bandit for nothing! He uses his one arm to pull on the slot machine Talladega Nights. Soon enough, he dies as well. That's too it. I want more than that. When he gets up, his stump is completely normal again. He uses this to pull the handle. Then his mole appears back on his face where it should be. It feels much better. It's like the movie Click, but in reverse.
What the fuck?
Change on your waiter, Clicks. Drop your waiter words right now. But that's... I'm going to undo all of that because that was supposed to be a story input for one thing.
It's like the movie Click in reverse.
I can't believe it mentioned Click.
I can't either.
It's because of Talladega Nights.
Oh my god, that's exactly what it is. And the machine pays out. Great, he can his own self pay out.
Dude, that's how you would talk if you got ripped in half and lost an arm.
Balance! He says, as the machine consolidates its weight while catapulting his dismembered limb across the room. I've been waiting my whole life to do that.
That is okay. What has happened to Donald is maybe the funniest thing that has ever happened in AI.
Balance.
Rips off one arm. Another machine rips off the other arm. All things are balanced.
This is kill me with my winnings. Kill me with my winnings! Donald screams. You walk over to the middle-aged man who is slightly past his prime as far as robbers go. Using your sword, you decapitate him quickly. What? No, let's throw it! Kill me with my winnings!
No.
Priceless Ming vases, some so ancient and rare that
it's got an eBay listing.
With that, Donald keels over and dies from exhaustion. You exit through the elevator doors, which rise up and away as soon as everyone has left. The group exits through a door into an ordinary parking lot. It's just Jackpot and Sam now, right?
Yeah, no, everybody else has either died or Gerd's character just won and moved to Banjo-Tooie.
Yeah, I moved into a video game.
I'm still crying about balance.
Balance! You're flinged across the room by the Talladega Nights machine. Just the fucking concept that a jackpot machine is so dangerous that by pulling the lever it just rips your arm off like instantly.
Jackpot asked Sam if you want to go get a milkshake or something. Sure, you say. After a few hours of driving, you arrive at a small roadside diner. You get out and stretch your legs, the waitress shows you to your table, and you order a milkshake.
The end.
Not the end, you can keep going a little bit longer.
I know. This is one of those two things.
Up to Scorpy, he's the only other person alive.
Yeah, it's just you two. No!
Oh shit! Sam spots a Talladega Nights machine in the diner and pulls the lever. Did you pull the lever, he asks? Yeah, you say. It's really hard to see in this light. I won! You gotta be shitting me.
Heh.
Okay, so I didn't get killed by the machine.
Because yeah, it's in the diner. Only the what was the other casino we were in called? The Lucky Dragon. Lucky Dragon. Yeah,
you posted it down. So you're just going to give up and go home? Jackpot asks with a hint of disappointment in his voice. I'll answer, I guess.
Give up? You murdered two people. We never did find Mom.
This is only slightly bass boosted. It's not like it's like genuinely bass boosted. Not like it's not HD sound.
We need to keep going to casinos because I must kill for Mom's foot. Well, Jackpot says, "What's the plan?" I don't know. I'm not sure.
I must kill for Mom's foot.
I'm not sure, but we gotta kill. Wrong.
Oh my god.
Wait, hang on. I wanted to do something.
Leave. We gotta kill. Yeah, we're on a quest.
We're on a quest, and I'll just delete this part.
We're on a quest.
Oh, my brain hurts so bad.
Balance.
Don't remind me. It's something from like fucking Xavier Renegade Angel.
Yeah, that's what it reminds me of. It really reminds me of like a PFR thing.
Mm-hmm. From fucking Magikarp Festival.
Jackpot orders a scary surprise off the menu. A few minutes later, the waitress brings out a lit stick of dynamite with a dollop of sour cream on top. Is this it? Jackpot asks. Yeah, she says. Do you want any straws or anything? That's all I need, he says. To go boom.
Oh my god. That's some Looney Tunes shit.
It's like that's the Grimdark Looney Tunes. That's the end!
I think we should.
Oh, I didn't even do
anything. Oh fuck, the El Dorado, let's go!
Yeah, I think we should go to the casino. I wanted it to just explode us.
Boom. Hang on. Hey, I gotta give mad ups to the three people in chat that made Zozo go bobble ba references when the word boom appeared.
The dynamite explodes, but we're fine. I can't get it to kill us, so maybe that should just be the end. It ends literally like a Looney Tunes sketch. The dynamite explodes and it goes.
That's how I imagine it too. Alright, that's the end of the story. We can do a couple top 10 lists if you want, and then call it a night. I don't even... Oh, my head hurts so bad. I laughed way too hard.
It coming up with, do you want any straws or anything for us?
That's all I need.
It's too funny.
Oh, there you go. We got the ending.
Sam turned into a DBZ character.
Sam executes Jackpot at point blank range. A bright light explodes in your face, blinding you. You feel your face disintegrate. You feel the bone and flesh tear away from your face.
Damn, I can't believe you could feel your face disintegrate. Ridiculous bandit.
We don't know what Jackpot's face looks like.
Alright, this is our last media share. Perfect timing. Literally the perfect amount of media shares. I'm glad I locked it when I did. I don't have to feel bad.
Oh, good idea.
Anybody missing out?
Your phone turned to ash.
Huh? Technical issue. It remains there's all eternity of avoiding brothers. You've been gotten every ending except pregnant.
Because that would be stupid.
It's calling back to when Sam asked for a baby.
You avoided the pregnancy ending.
The feral. Oh.
I want to see what our casino rank is. Your casino rank is dead.
And
wait, hang on. I want a different. I want a different casino rank. I want to see. I want to see how we did. Did we, get the high score? Wow, it's only once to be dead. Master Thief. You could replace your face with a different one.
Yeah, no more crumpled paper.
See if we can get a good one.
This was absolutely the best AI dungeon story we've done in like a year, I feel like.
Master of the ridiculous.
It's about drive, it's about power, it's about glory, the old man says. You made choices and now the story ends.
Damn right. It really keeps ending things.
Yeah, AI dungeon gets in that mood.
Oh, okay. Nice.
A song for his wife. Why is his wife's name Mrs. Tatum?
Hello, Mrs. Tatum. My favorite The Rock song.
Oh, shit.
You're beautiful. A song for, they're all a song for his wife. A fun foot in hell.
Thank you everybody for donating and doing media shares. If you contributed to that, thank you very much. Hold on, let me move the credits for you so you can still read everything. Credits over here. What? What was that? I'm radio TV. Is back. I mean, I am. This is the first stream after 8 days of no streaming. I am back. Are the top tens didn't last too long. I mean, I would have done more, but my head. I'll sit here and watch a few of them. I mean, falls in a Bernoulli hole. It keeps wanting to tell a story. It's addicted to this story. Exactly, Griff Grab. Someone asked what the outro song I use is. It's called Binary Rondo by Soichi Terada.
Free.
You spend the rest of the time until 6 p.m. sitting around screen. Jetbot's face appears on the shirt.
Well, it's about bloody time.
Yeah.
It can't even do top 10 lists right now.
All right, it's here like, we go.
It's that busted.
Let's try
We've
this.
Got new merch. Like this t-shirt featuring Jatchpot.
And this would feature Sam. And this would feature Jatch. And this would feature Dawn.
This is the official Wayne Radio t-shirt. Now you can play a game of dress up. Pick your favorite character. He's got a big head and a massive guitar, and he's a rock star. He's obnoxious. He's cringeworthy. He's awesome. The Rock starts to sing. You're so beautiful. You're so ugly. You're a goddess. Which is new as the dishes of the rules include. That's a flying kick.
Which will be the referee of the match.
part is lowering it. You and your partner score a big win.
Heh.
Heh.
Dawned.
Something about this story is just making it completely inconducive to top 10 lists. It just doesn't want to do them.
The crowd is going insane.
The Dawn crowd explodes. Dawn pulls the lever and the machine activates and the crowd explodes.
The bot really loves this story, as it should. This story is amazing. Thank you, PB Man 2000. Don't think I missed you. I see you on the credits. His arm.
His arm.
Is raised in
victory. It's raised in victory.
Oh, all right, I gotta wrap this up. Thank you for tuning in. Oh, I forgot the sleeping Dobby, the shitty fucking chop job I did on that picture. Thank you everybody for tuning in. Next stream, I don't know when it'll be, but it was supposed to come out today. Prop Night comes out tomorrow, so I want to stream that soon. Also, hopefully I'll be getting into the VHS beta soon, which is another Dead by Daylight tech game that I want to stream. And Dead by Daylight's got a new killer, so I want to stream that. Other stuff is planned, of course, but streams hopefully should be more regular from here on out.
Oh my goodness.
For a good while. And remember, more gnome videos coming soon. Please, please, I implore you and I beg of you, please share the gnome videos with your friends. Or if you haven't watched them yet, go to youtube.com/c/WaymeRadioTV. People are like, I don't want any Alex spoilers, I won't watch this. But here's the thing. It's not really that much of a spoiler. It's a little bit of a spoiler. But just don't watch it to the end. There you go. But yeah, tell your friends, comment on the gnome videos, let everyone know how much you like the gnome and how you think he's not annoying. So that the algorithm says, hey, this video is great, and it shows it to the world. That's all we need. But yeah, next gnome video should be in a week or two. Probably within the week. I've been working on it hard every day. Also, no, he's not paying attention to the actual game story. Yeah, we're making our own story. The gnome is annoying. Dislike. I got a comment today from like some person with like a little kid avatar, so clearly a little kid that's just like, what the fuck, man? Where HOVRAI? Come on! It was just like really desperate. It's sad. And he censored his fuck with 4 pound signs for some reason. Alright, guys. Time to call it a night. Friends of AI Dungeon who played the game with me, do you have any final words for our chat? Oh god, what the fuck are you typing?
Yeah, don't go back. Don't look back at the AI Dungeon. No, don't do that. This is a treat for us.
Did it generate that?
Oh god.
Did any of you guys type in that line that started with P?
No, what? Yes. Someone yes. Asked to her. I don't know. It wasn't me.
Twitch dick moment. You have a nice twitchy. What?
What the fuck is smooth as onion? Is that a saying?
I'm gonna read this. Go offline. The story got really sexual. 18 plus, 18 below, tune out now. It says Twitch dick moment number one. You reach around, grab her beautiful, delicate, smooth as onion, pink twitching onion, and you pop her in your mouth.
Twitching onion.
You decide to tickle her to death. What the fuck? What the fuck? fuck, this stream has to end now. This stream has to end now.
Oh no.
This stream and now, this has been a
film! A product of Gang Bang Productions. G-Snoozer!
It is for you to decide whether this ending is reality or simply illusion.